1. Welcome to Youngstown, Ohio, Stambaugh Stadium. They call it the Ice Castle. And we are finding out today why, as we are out in the elements on the roof of the press box. Brian, Sean, Lee Timmerman with you, bringing this telecast of NDSU football to you statewide on NBC North Dakota Sports. North Dakota State, after faltering at home to South Dakota, has rattled off 3 straight wins and are 7-2 and hope to finish off the regular season road schedule with a victory here today against the Penguins.
Well, what happens today, Brian, just so much sets up the next month, I think, for NDSU. I know that's making an assumption. There's still a game to play, but it is Missouri State next week. So today is obviously the focus, and today is the big one for the Bison.
Youngstown State, as we mentioned a bit in the pregame, a tough team to figure out. 5-4 coming in, 3-3 in the Valley. They've looked impressive at times, but then there's other times, LT, where they have not shown up. And a month ago here, when South Dakota State came to Youngstown, they got walloped 38-8.
Well, I think the bigger issue for the Penguins has been on the offensive side of the ball, kind of what you're mentioning. I think their defense has been fairly solid so far this year. So it'll be interesting to see. I shouldn't say what the Bison want to do. We know what they want to do. Coach Polisic says we want to establish the run. We want to stay with the run. And then we want to run some more. So that's what you want to see if you're a Bison fan today.
And North Dakota State, we should mention, does lead the Valley in rushing yards, and they are number one against the run in the Missouri Valley as well, giving up just 100 yards a game. And Youngstown State, Bo Pelini said earlier this week, the first-year head coach at Youngstown, that he wants to be able to run the football, but with some of the musical chairs on the offensive line this year, might make that difficult today.
And there's the guy you're looking at right there. It's going to be the key to that run. I know that he's going to hand it off to King Frazier and some of the other backs, but we've seen that in his starts, what NDSU has been able to do with Easton Stick in the running game, and he will once again be a big factor in what happens on the ground for NDSU today.
Yeah, amazing what Easton Stick has come in and accomplished in just 3 starts. Second on the team in rushing with 364 yards. He's averaging 8 yards a carry. He's also thrown for 7 touchdowns and completing 58% of his passes. As North Dakota State gets set to take on the Penguins here, we should mention that the Bison will finish off next week's, well, the whole schedule next week against Missouri State at home. We'll have that game for you. It is senior day for the Bison. And as you mentioned a little bit earlier, LT, setting up the rest of the schedule. If you can get that bye week and potentially get a top 4 seed in the playoffs, we've seen how tough it is for them to win in the Fargo Dome. Beth Houle is on the sidelines for us today and has a sideline report, the PetroServe USA sideline report. Beth.
Hey guys, a really cool moment. You're talking about senior day for Youngstown State today and all the emotion that goes with that. Well, head coach Chris Kleiman's son had his last high school football game yesterday at the Fargo Dome. Shanley playing in the North Dakota 2A state championship game, and Coach Kleiman got to be there. That's the kind of thing that as a head football coach in college, you miss out on a lot of those special moments. But Coach Kleiman had the opportunity to be there thanks to Matt Larson and Jack Mon, two important guys at NDSU. That's for certain. Coach Kleiman today talking to him pregame said how important that was to him, how special of a moment that was, and how much it meant to him and his son Devin for him to be able to be there.
Beth, thank you very much. And yeah, Chris did not fly with the team, came out a little bit later in the day last night, and certainly a special moment, I'm sure, for him and his son to celebrate that moment.
And on the field earlier today, when Coach was during warm-ups, Coach Kleiman was walking off, and I just shook his hand and I said, hey, I was glad that you were able to experience that. And he just said, me too, smiled, and went back in to address the team.
So the team shake hands, and the Bison will get set to take on Youngstown State. One guy to watch for the Penguins defensively, Derek Rivers, junior defensive tackle, defensive end, plays it both in and out. And LT, he's been the most disruptive player on this team, has 7 sacks.
In terms of guys who are starting on the line, they have a guy that plays behind him too, Lee Wright. We're going to see him all over the place and say his name a lot. Those two guys are probably the top two guys that make this defense go. And I know an interesting way I thought that Coach Polisic described Wright. He said as a defensive player, he has big play potential, and he will wear number 5 for the Penguins today. But yeah, Rivers wears number 11, kind of an odd defensive end number, so you'll be able to pick him out a little bit. He is a major concern with what he's been able to do to get into the backfield.
And NDSU did win the toss. They did defer, so Youngstown State will have the ball first today, and a lot of pressure on this Youngstown State offense to be able to run the football. That's been a struggle at times for the Penguins.
Yeah, they haven't been able to just get it done. I mean, their stats don't look that bad. I mean, they're averaging 200 yards rushing, but it's always kind of how you get inside those numbers. And Youngstown, you know, we say that they've struggled. They have, but they still come into this game winners of two in a row, and a team that has playoff aspirations. In order to do that, the Penguins have to win out.
Yeah, the Penguins believe, talking to him this week, that they win today and they win next week. They believe that they will get a playoff spot as we get set for another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed, and the ball blows off the tee. As you see, the winds are howling and swirling a bit here at Stambaugh Stadium.
Yeah, they're kind of from where our cameras are and the way you're viewing it at home. It's kind of over your left shoulder is kind of the way the wind is blowing. So when you get off to the left, there's the big flag. It's blowing. That is, you know, off to the left here, which would be north in this stadium.
And the winds are supposed to die down, supposedly, as the day goes on. We'll see if that comes to fruition. Taken at the 2-yard line. That is Jody Webb. And Webb busting through a seam and out to the 27-yard line. He is dragged down on the play by Levi Jordheim. And Youngstown State will start off their first possession from there.
Jordheim could have a little bit bigger role today, playing some third down defensive end. We saw him do it weeks ago. He might get called on to do a little bit more of that today as well, and we know what he has done all season on special teams.
Youngstown State offense led by Hunter Wells, the true sophomore from Navarre, Ohio, completing just 56% of his passes, 13 touchdowns and 7 interceptions. And the biggest problem for Hunter at times has just been the consistency.
Yeah, he's made a mistake, a costly mistake. You will see two quarterbacks today, too. So when Rivers comes in, don't think that anything happened to Wells. It's a rotation kind of, not even a true rotation, but they've used two QBs.
Inside handoff, not much room for Martin Ruiz. He has about a yard up to the 29-yard line. We'll bring up second and long. Here's your Shield starting lineup, starting with the North Dakota State University defense. The big guys up front may have a decent advantage today, especially Nate Tanguay and Brian Schatz. Nick DeLuca, a monster game last week and the week before, playing very high at a high level. Trey Dempsey and Robbie Grimsley, the tandem at safety for NDSU.
You know, Wells is a freshman last year, played a lot, but I don't think he's improved a lot from year one to two.
This one swung out in a double coverage. And it is caught for a first down, making the reception one of the backup tight ends. That is Shane Coon, I should say. There's a look at your Youngstown State offense. Hunter Wells, as we mentioned, the quarterback. Martin Ruiz felt like he's been here forever, the longtime running back out of Florida. Stubbs.
Same with Williams.
And Williams have a lot of reps underneath them here at Youngstown State. Now, that we did talk about the offensive line a bit. That is makeshift. They got three different starters in there from what they started the season with.
The Bison field heading into this game that they have an advantage with their four against YSU's five.
This one swung out in the flat, and there is an open receiver, and there goes Webb. Jody Webb pushed out of bounds. Right around the 25-yard line, and Youngstown State an explosive play on their first drive.
Well, that's how Youngstown has been able to get into the red zone this year, with big plays, not long sustained drives. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You saw one of the safeties, I think it was Dempsey, took a poor angle, got himself out of the play, and then the seam opened up down the sideline. So that is a one-on-one play that has to be made most of the time by a safety. If it doesn't, it's a big play.
This is Ricky Davis with his first carry. Davis into the game. The backup quarterback, as you mentioned, LT, primarily a runner.
Yeah, Davis has not thrown many balls so far this year. He did throw a few more, I think it was last week, but he is designed to be the runner. And again, you saw him move in, move out, so it's not a big deal. They've been doing it. Actually, it's kind of helped this Youngstown offense. And one of the things, they brought the offensive coordinator from up top down to the sideline, and that's when they started to use more of that tandem quarterback.
Second and eight coming up from the 23. Plenty of time. Will fire to the sideline. Open receiver. Caught. And he is in for a touchdown. And that is Coon, the tight end.
I wonder if he was forced out of bounds. Kuhn went out. He stepped out, but was he forced out? Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. This is not going to stand because Kuhn was out of bounds. He came back in, and if you're not forced out, you cannot be the first guy to touch it, and that's what happened. This is not going to stand.
And that's Bo Pelini. He's hoping for a force out, but I think they've made the call.
Boy, on the opening drive, though, from your home team game on senior day, and you take a touchdown off the board, you don't hear the Penguins. You don't certainly don't want to see that. But Kuhn's been interesting in goal line situations. He has some rushing touchdowns from a fullback position.
Yeah, Kuhn, a guy that they really like to use. Okay, this in the red zone in particular.
On this replay, though, Brian, we're picking it up after. Nice little stick there, too, by Dempsey. But we're picking it up after Kuhn has already stepped out. Here's Wells setting up. And now watch the hat from the head linesman. See when he whips his hat down? That means that he saw something go out. He's going to check with some other officials to determine whether he was forced out or he went out on his own. Went out on his own. Cannot be the first guy to touch it.
So that is a huge call from the officials and the correct call, and takes a touchdown off the board for the Penguins. I still think they're trying to figure out where to mark it off. Bo is not happy about that.
It's going,
obviously.
It could be a long day for that head linesman, because he's the guy that made the call and he's also the guy working the Youngstown sideline. So he'll have Mr. Pelini. He'll be close to him throughout the day.
They have not marked off the penalty yet. The 23 was the original line of scrimmage, so I believe they will have to move the football back here. Unless it's just a loss of down, LT.
Yeah, because the third down went up on the down marker.
Right.
Throughout the day, we'll talk a little bit more about Pelini. If you do not know his background, he was a Power 5 head coach at Nebraska.
So third and 8 from the 23.
See if the Bison can take advantage of the break on the step out.
Good drop. Wells has time. Fires in the flat. This is caught by Ruiz. Keeps his feet. Has a first down inside the 15. Down to the 13-yard line.
When Youngstown is successful on offense, they do a good job. Webb, we saw with a big play. Ruiz, they work these kids out of the backfield, get them in one-on-one situations. You see him slip past DeLuca, and then Dempsey has to come and clean up. So despite having the touchdown wiped off, YSU was able to get the first down.
And Youngstown State in the Superior Inc. red zone for the first time today. And the Penguins, about 56% of the time is the time that they score touchdowns once in the red zone. As you take a look at Ricky Davis as the quarterback shuffle continues here for the Penguins. Davis high snap, going to run. Davis has room. Ricky Davis, touchdown.
Boy, the Penguins were able to open up the seam that time. Pulled one of the guys out in front. Big 77 takes care of the leading tackler, and then Robbie Grimsley was not in a position to make the tackle as Davis splits the safeties right up that seam.
And Youngstown State marches right down the field and into the end zone for an early 6-0 lead. Impressive drive for the home team on senior day. They are playing for their playoff lives and certainly coming out with some urgency right away. The extra point. He is knocked through by Zach Kennedy, a true freshman from right here in Youngstown, and Youngstown State leads it 7-0 on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard.
So that's, I guess, more or less, there's a good example of the quarterback tandem in the way that YSU, especially the last two, for sure, maybe 3 weeks that they've been able to use it.
And Davis, one of those guys that, again, has only thrown 14 passes, but he has run for 120 yards and 3 touchdowns. And we'll take a timeout and be back. Youngstown leads it 7-0. Zach Kennedy kicking one away on another Peterson Farm seat. Wind dated of Bruce Anderson will take it 6 yards deep and take an E, and the Bison will start at their own 25. So the Bison offense will take the field for the first time. under Easton Stick. The Bison racking up 59 points and over 500 yards of offense last week against Western Illinois, and a majority of that damage done on the ground.
Certainly, all, you know, 971 yards rushing the last three games for NDSU, and we told you what Coach Polasek thought, you know, coming into this game, and that will be exactly what the NDSU will want to do again, establish the ground game.
Run up the middle for King Frazier. He gains about 3 yards. Check that two up to the 27-yard line. Take a look at our starting lineup for the North Dakota State offense, brought to you by Shields. Jedry Sear, the senior, the fullback. Frazier has certainly earned that starting spot at running back. Zach Vaughn, Erzendowski, nice tandem of receivers. Of course, the offensive line intact and relatively healthy here heading into November, which is a big key for the NDSU success on the ground.
Yeah, the Bison want to see early on if they can move the front four of the Penguins.
Stick will throw, and this one is caught. Ankle tackle at the 36-yard line as Bruce Anderson makes the reception.
Well, the Bison trying there to do some of the same things that YSU was able to. Nodak Mutual Insurance, and that's get a replay, I should say, and that's get one of your better playmakers. That's as Anderson one-on-one on the outside on the edge.
Take a look at your Shield starting lineup for that Youngstown State defense. And again, keep an eye on the two defensive ends, in particular, number 11, Derek Rivers, all-time sack leader here at Youngstown State. Lee Wright, Delavode, and Eric Thompson, a tandem of three young linebackers, but doing a nice job so far for the Penguins this season. 2 yard gain up the middle that time for Frazier. That will bring up second and eight.
Look like a zone kind of read option. The one thing Coach Hedberg said with Easton Stick in the running game at first, early on, they wanted him to err on the side of handing the ball off. So don't expose himself too much early. They want to see some things on how Youngstown is going to defend. So that's not a surprise that the first type of a look like that was a handoff.
And Frazier, something to prove. Of course, he was a walk-on at Nebraska under Bo Pelini and then transferred to North Dakota State. Frazier again gets the call, keeps his feet, and dragged down nicely by Williams of Youngstown State to bring up third and six.
That'll be an interesting look for NDSU this week, today with the jet. If you're going to hand it, they're trying to figure out how Youngstown is going to defend it, whether they're going to run a defender all the way through with the wide receiver, or if they're going to kind of just tag off, just say, you got him, you got him, you got him, as he runs through the formation. Big third down here for the Bison. They want to stay on the field.
Third and six from the 40. Three receivers to the near side of your screen there. Stick will throw. Stick underneath, caught. First catch of the day for Darius Shepherd across 50 down to the 48-yard line. Good enough for a first down.
I thought Stick was looking at two people, the guy who caught the ball or also Bonnet. They ran a little bit of an X across right in front of the face of both linebackers. And as a quarterback, you're trying to decide who's going with who. Well, two guys went with Bonnet. Shepherd was able to stay open. There you see it. Bonnet takes care of two guys, hits one, and it keeps Shepherd wide open to pick up that very important third down. The Bison this year have been so good on third down, third best in the FCS.
Youngstown State, by the way, number one in the country against the pass. Only about 115 yards a game is what they're giving up. Empty formation here for Easton Stick. And Stick will run. Youngstown State ready for it. Gain of one up to the 47. Saw a defensive back crashing down there for the Penguins and coming in to make the play. Number 18, DJ Thomas.
Bison pulled, tried to get Zach Johnson out in front of that, but the hole closed up before Johnson was able to even get a block on anyone. That was defended very well.
Second and nine. Stick will run. Not much room again. Youngstown State fitting up those runs pretty well. Delavode in on the tackle that time after a gain of two. Now we'll bring up another third and long for NDSU.
Well, that time on the jet motion, the corner handed off the guy who comes through. And so he's in there to help on the tackle and seal the outside. So again, it only gained a couple of yards. You got third and long again, but that's the type of things that the offensive coordinator and the offensive staff will put in the back of their mind on how that play was defended right there and maybe make an adjustment off of it.
Third and eight from the 46. Stick throwing back shoulder fade. Boy, was that a nice catch by Jeff Ilias, the sophomore from Winemere. Makes the adjustment and comes up with it.
Man, he was covered too, so I don't know how this ball squeezed in there. Stick threw it low, threw it hard, and made Ilias make the adjustment on it. Here comes your Nodak Mutual Insurance replay right at you. Bang, yeah. Ilias knew it was coming. Defensive back did not.
Only the fifth reception of the year for Ilias. And the Bison able to convert once again on third down.
I said defensive back. That was actually right on the coverage. So that might be a situation. The Bison like the tight end on a linebacker.
Jet motion run. And boy, Demetri Williams lost the football and picked up by Youngstown State.
No, down. They're marking him down.
Emmanuel Croma came up with the football, but again, North Dakota State, as LT mentioned, will keep it, fortunately. Take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Boy, the corner crashes really hard. You see the tackle, the hit, and I don't know if that ball was on its way out or not.
But I don't know if there's enough there to overturn it. Again, ruled down on the field. They can take a look at this.
Nope,
it was down.
That's a great
elbow
replay,
came
guys.
Down. So NDSU, fortunately, will hang on to the football here.
The other thing today, I don't know if our telecast or the other guys are the replays either.
Yeah, there is.
Never asked about that.
Yeah, there is two television broadcasts today. Youngstown is doing one, and of course, we're doing one. So, and the Bison will call a timeout. Unsure, maybe. What's going on in the offense? They did get to the line relatively late out of the huddle, and we will take a timeout as well. 7-0 Youngstown State, 6:05 to go on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. All right, North Dakota State, second and long coming up. Handoff goes to Frazier, and King Frazier at the 29-yard line, gets a good chunk of that yardage back. Pick up with seven. We'll bring up third and five.
Bison working the edge right in on that tackle once again. But that's the play, too, or a similar style of play, or the area that NDSU in its running game the last couple of weeks has been very successful in getting some things out on the edge, that off-tackle side or maybe bumped out from there yet.
So North Dakota State has found a way to keep the chains moving in all these situations on this drive.
Unbalanced to the left with power to the left, but now Wentz moves to make it balanced.
They're going to run the football, and Frazier steps out of one tackle. He's going to, now he's going backwards. Frazier around the edge, no gain back to the 29, and that thing bubbled out nicely by the defensive lineman there for Youngstown State. I think Rivers was one, or was it?
I think the first guy there.
Oh, it was actually Croma.
Oh, Croma was? Okay, first guy there, and then Frazier does actually a really nice job in order to get back to the line of scrimmage, because you saw him get hit a couple of different times. But yeah, that play got blown up right away.
The Bison Piers are going to go for it here on fourth and six.
The kick would be into the wind or the wind side of the stadium.
Fourth and six from the 30. Stick will roll. Stick running out of time. Stick stays on his feet. Easton Stick is going to be short, and the ball came loose, and Youngstown State holds and will have the football.
Now, he was short anyway. The ball did come out. You saw Anderson jump right back on top of it, but the Penguins were getting the ball back either way. Trying to look for someone in the flat, now looking for the third receiver trailing in, and by this time, Stick just doesn't have any opportunity to pass it, and that was a real good separation there. Delavade, wasn't that who got the hit?
Delavade, just a true freshman. Another timeout, 7-0. Youngstown State still leads it on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard.
Hey.
Youngstown State has the football back, 7-0 here, 4:38 to go as the Hopes team Penguins starting off this game strong, getting a big fourth down stop as Martin Ruiz picks up about a half yard on first down for the Penguins. Mookie Davis back into the football game. He and Hunter Wells have been swapping out snaps here most of the first quarter. Davis will throw it, and this one zips right through the hands of Andre Stubbs. Incomplete, will bring up third and long, and Davis took a shot.
Now Davis will come back, and Wells will go back in. I think when you saw Wells too last year, didn't you think that he was going to just really become one of the elite guys in this league after he got a little experience? And I think he kind of flattened out, is what I've been told, from kind of freshman year to sophomore year.
Well, again, Wells did play as a true freshman, had a huge game at South Dakota State last year, 256 yards and 3 touchdowns. And yeah, the production has been there at times. He's played pretty well so far here today, but it just hasn't been consistent across the board.
New look, empty, 5 receivers out.
Osmo rush 4. Wells under pressure. Wells going to try to take off with it, but he is not going to get anywhere near the first down. And the Bison hold on third down as Trey Dempsey comes in to make the stop with Brian Schatz, among others.
Brad Ambrosius looked like the guy who was able to get a hold of the jersey and not let Wells come out. Watch off the left side. That's Menard. Yep, then Ambrosius is able to corral him. I mean, to be honest with you, folks, we're so far away from the field, it's a little hard to see. You're seeing the game at home better than we are, just to let you know.
And even with the sun, it's made it even more challenging. Eric Perkins, we know, is back at the 30-yard line for the punt. And this one hangs up in the wind. Pretty nice punt. Perkins
hit it.
And got back on top of it, I think, was NDSU. And yes, the official says Perkins got it, but his own blocker there in front.
Yeah, that's why it was not fair catch interference, because it was the Bison guy that actually hit Perkins, and the same guy that just nipped Perkins is the one who was on the bottom of that pile. Perkins didn't get it back.
So NDSU fortunate to hang on to the football here in what's been a topsy-turvy first quarter for the visiting team. Take a look at the Nodag Mutual Insurance replays. See Perkins calling for the fair catch, and it's Jalen Allison.
Takes the left foot of Perkins out, and then the ball, luckily for the Bison, rolls right to Allison.
The official right there on top of it. So NDSU will start from their own 23-yard line, first and 10.
Yeah, the one thing the Bison do not want to repeat on that first drive, what, 2 third and longs, and then a fourth and medium. So more production on first down. That's what NDSU's looking for.
Inside handoff. Another run for King Frazier. Pretty good movement that time up front. He gained 6 up to the 29.
Frazier looked like he was probably another step and a half deeper in that formation than he normally is. And I think to give him an extra, split second to look and pick his way through. It wasn't a pull. It wasn't a power. It was his own type of a play. So just seeing which direction you can move the defensive line, and then it's up to the tailback to pick. He did not have a lead blocker, as there is a fullback in now.
Line up the motion man there. Play action. Bonnet open in the flat, makes the catch, and Bonnet runs over a tackler down to the 40-yard line, and enough for a first down. Tackled on the play by Jameel Smith.
Well, I was expecting him to hurdle. like we've seen him do so many times, but a well-designed play. Bonnet was just kind of got lost in the shuffle with the flow of the play, moving off to the offense's left. They just slip him out in the flat. Nobody there, so they fly it. Just able to slip it out there. Well-executed play. Linebackers just lost track of where Bonnet was.
Tight formation here once again on first and 10. Bison will run it. That's Chase Morlock's first carry. He's got 3 yards up to the 42.
Outside G, pull the guy around.
This game brought to you in high definition by Speak Volumes, reminding you that one drink is not always one drink. Log on to speakvolumes.nd.gov for more information.
Morlock is just, as Coach Polasek said to us this week, he's just not going to be back to 100%. He's been dealing with that ankle, that high ankle. There's a good look at Chase right there in the fullback position right now, but that ankle's been giving him fits.
Back to the ground game. Stretch play. Frazier met right at the line of scrimmage. Coming in was Lee Wright. Also Avery Moss, the transfer from Nebraska, coming in.
Boy, so far Youngstown's getting out there and turning the play in. That's the main thing right there. Is you see Darsh, he's a transfer from Miami, number 8, plays corner. He does not let that play to get outside of him. That's his job. Turn it in, make sure it does not go out, because that's where your help is. And the flow so far, I think, from Youngstown, they've been flowing to the ball pretty well so far today.
North Dakota State, 2 of 3 on third down here so far today.
And they're staring at a 3rd and 5 right here, 3rd and 4.
Stick, swings it out, incomplete. The intended target was Bruce Anderson. And the Penguins hold again on defense, and the Bison will have to punt. Good coverage on the play once again for Youngstown, Eric Thompson.
Thompson right on it. He's the 5th defensive back. Plays that nickel. Doesn't go into the box a whole lot, so he's mostly the 3rd safety in a situation like that. He was all over that play. Even if it's caught and the tackle's made, it would still be short.
The Cops will angle this one towards the corner.
Great punt.
Maybe too good. We'll see.
Oh, great punt. Yep, too good.
And it bounces into the end zone, and NDSU unable to hold it at the 1. Boy, the Cop did a nice job of burying it deep, but DeLuca and Board, first down there, were not able to hold it. And the Penguins will have it at the 20. So far, LT, we thought maybe NDSU would be able to run the ball in particular in the middle, and they have not been able to move Youngstown yet as much as I think they'd like to.
No, most of those plays have been going to the outside edge a little bit more, but the lack of production on first down has been the thing so far that has hurt the Bison more than anything.
Youngstown State, 3rd possession. Wells back in at quarterback. There's 38 seconds left here in the first quarter. Motion man is Stubbs. Stubbs dragged down. Nice defensive play. And oh boy, Brad Ambrosius has made a couple of big plays here in the first quarter.
Well, Ambrosius has shown us if he can get his hand on your jersey, you're not going any further. The Jet plays off the block to get back into the play. Bison had him turned up real well anyway. I don't think that play was going to get, you know, more than 2 or 3 yards tops, but here it goes as a tackle for loss for Ambrosius. His 5th of the year, actually 6th of the year.
And that will do it for the first quarter, a rapidly moving first quarter. Youngstown State leads at 7-0 on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. More from Stambaugh Stadium when we return on NBC North Dakota Sports. Let's take a look at our North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. 1 acre is about the size of what common playing field? We'll have the answer here coming up in just a little bit.
And you might be looking at one right now.
It's a possibility. Youngstown State, 2nd and 11 from their own 19.
Bison certainly could use another 3 and out.
Wells to throw. This one in the flat, dangerous throw, incomplete. And a flag comes in, and I think they're going to get C.J. Smith for a late hit on Andrew Williams.
Grimsley saying, I tipped it. Because if the pass is tipped, and I thought Grimsley did tip it.
Yeah, that ball was
definitely
hit.
Definitely tipped. So,
or I think it was the late hit afterwards by C.J.
He hit him late anyway, so I guess that's if it's a dead ball situation, then, yeah, it doesn't matter. Yep, dead ball.
So instead of a 3rd and 11, Youngstown State will get it all the way up at the 34 and a first down. Big penalty there on the Bison.
Huge penalties. That's the difference between during the course of the play or the dead ball situation after the play. Because Grimsley did get a hand on it.
Davis back in the game here for Youngstown. One back to each side of the shotgun. First and 10 from the 34. Inside handoff, not much room. Bison had that one covered up pretty well. Gain of maybe two.
The one thing about that play, though, from the Bison perspective, is if you're on the outside, on the high side, you better make sure that you read the dive correctly, because otherwise that's going to pull out and an option.
North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. 1 acre is about the size of what common playing football field? LT, you guessed it. Another one correct. A football field.
That is maybe our easiest soybean trivia of the year.
I would have to say so. Second and 8. Davis will run. Davis has room again, and the shifty Ricky Davis inside NDSU territory all the way down to the 42.
Well, we've just seen why Ricky Davis is in there and is known as a running quarterback, because he makes a couple of really nice moves. The best one is coming up right there on Grimsley. He makes him whiff on it, makes another guy miss, and gets another across midfield and about another 8 yards after that.
And the Penguins playing confident, leading 7-0 as they drive it down to the 42.
You know, the Bison defense, the penalty put themselves in this position, so they're going to have to try to dig out of it.
Davis again will run again, and this time the Bison swallow him up back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. Brian Schatz, Robbie Grimsley, Brian looked like Caleb Butler in there.
Here's a good look at Caleb Butler. Boy, he has played his way onto the field after coming on as a walk-on, getting some work at defensive end.
The Bison are without Stanley Jones today. The redshirt freshman from Bismarck has a knee problem, will not be available likely until the playoffs. Should the Bison get there? Wells back in, will throw a screen, and that's it behind his intended target and incomplete.
Trying to hit Williams. Williams is a kid who can break a big two. We've seen that over the years. He can take a short pass and make it a long touchdown.
So another third and long coming up here for Youngstown State, and they will keep Hunter Wells on the field.
Wells actually looked like he had two options, because he also had Webb looking like he was running a wheel to the high side.
Wells will get the call from the sideline.
Now Smith backs off a little bit of Williams without the safety on his side. Looks like Bison is showing single high. Nope, they go to two.
Wells across the middle, open receiver, and that is Webb, and he's got a first down to the 29.
Another third and long, third and 10. You're able to convert it and stay on the field. That's exactly what an offense wants to do. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Wells looks down on some verticals, nothing there early on. He knows he has Webb coming out of the backfield, and Webb, the junior, is able to pick up the first down. Pretty good tandem, that Ruiz and Webb.
Yeah, two receptions now, 46 yards for Jody Webb, who is a very dynamic running slash scat back for this Penguin offense. And that's the one thing these running backs do very well for YSU, is catch the football. Stubbs the motion man. Davis has it. Davis will throw. And this one out of the reach of his intended target and incomplete. And again, they were looking for the tight end. Or excuse me, Jody Webb was the intended target, not the tight end.
I think Davis may be lucky that the pass was thrown so poorly, because I think Grimsley was in a perfect position that if he tries to line drive that one in there, he might have been able to come up with a pick. Because it was actually thrown inside of where the safety even was, so that didn't have much of a chance to hit his intended receiver.
Just the 15th pass attempt of the season for Ricky Davis. Second and 10. Wells to throw, has time. Now throws across the middle, and he was hit as he threw it. Could not really step into the throw, and incomplete. Short hopped his receiver.
Bison running some games with their down defensive lineman. That time running a little cross, a little X on the right side, and the inside rush. So it was the defensive end was able to get a real good hit on Wells. He had no chance to step into that throw.
It's another third and long.
And the NDSU is going to do a lot of that type of gameplay with its defensive line because of the inconsistency that Youngstown has shown the last couple of weeks. Even though they haven't given up a sack, you know, until today in the last 2 weeks, they still have been susceptible to games along the defensive line.
Wells, time again, fires that one out of the reach, and a flag comes in.
There's some hand play. Both the players were kind of on each other when the ball was in the air.
Oh boy, this would be another first down on a third down and long.
Here comes the flag. You see it on the replay. That's Williams trying a little stop route right at the down marker, about a yard past the down marker. Smith was on him.
Offensive pass interference.
Well, they were both going at each other pretty good. And to be honest with you, as we see the ISO, they both had contact.
So the Bison will obviously decline the penalty. Oh, no, they're going to take it.
Make it.
And knock them out of field goal range. Make it to third and 25 from the 45.
From that replay that we just saw, it looked like whoever they were going to call that on was going to be a tough call.
Yeah, I would agree.
Against whichever player you were going to pick to be at fault.
So third and 25 from the 44.
That's why you take it, though. It's because it's the 15-yard penalty.
Bison will drop seven into coverage and only rush four. Wells will dump it off again to Webb. And this time the Bison have it covered as he's only able to get to the 36.
Important tackle there for Stumpf to make. If MJ doesn't make that tackle, then Webb's running into potential field goal range, even though it would have been a tough field goal. But this is a nice open field tackle. Just put your running back in space and you're counting on your one-on-one defense to make the play.
It's actually Ruiz who made the catch, not Webb's. First catch of the day for Martin Ruiz. Youngstown will try to pin the Bison deep. Coming on fourth and 16. Flag will come out and they will probably try to take the 5-yard penalty and give the punter, Nick Shealy, a little more room.
Well, that drive was influenced on big penalties on each team, was it, at the beginning of it that prevented NDSU from getting the 3 and out? Then the offensive pass interference that made it the 3rd and 25.
Chris Kleiman will decline the penalty and make Youngstown punt it right where they are. C.J. Smith is deep for NDSU at his own 10. Shealy.
Have to field it.
Going to hang it up. And it'll go out of bounds. Right around the 13, 14, 15-yard line. We'll see where the official marks it. And it will be the 15. 7-0, Youngstown State. We're back with more second quarter action from Stambaugh Stadium after this. Take a look at our new seed fan cam. Plenty of Bison faithful making it down here and plenty of seats available here in Youngstown. I know what you think, LT, 6,000?
Maybe.
And the sun has peaked out. Beautiful day as Easton Stick will go to work for the Bison offense. And Steak has a wide open receiver downfield. It's Fraw. Zach Fraw inside the 30. Trying to make a move, still running, and finally dragged down, and he was wide open as the touchdown-saving tackle was made by Leroy Alexander, and a big play there for North Dakota State on first down.
Why do you leave the guy flying down the field? There's a vertical and an out. There you see the out, and for some reason, the safety goes to the out, leaves Fraw wide open, and that's the big hit play of the Bison, and then Alexander does a good job of preventing the touchdown. He was playing catch-up from the other side of the field.
62 yards on the pitch and catch in North Dakota State. Excuse me, 72 yards. As NDSU is in the Superior Inc. red zone for the first time today. Stick will throw again, and Stick is going to take off and run. Inside the 15, the 10, and slides down at the 8-yard line and took a shot at the end.
That was Wright that was staring right at him. So Kodak Mutual Insurance replaced Dick surveying, and then he just sees the whole thing open up. And there's number five, Wright. Dick tries to get down. He does get his head out of the way. That's the main thing, and whether you take a shot to the noggin or not, it looks like Houston was able to get out of the way of that.
We've talked about North Dakota State in the red zone, how effective they are. Been in there 35 times this season. They've scored touchdowns 26 of them.
Now that's outstanding. 3/4 of the time.
So second and a short one here for the Bison inside the 10. Cruising Dallas be the motion man. Stick will keep it. He's got a blocker in front and a tripped up. No gain. Nice play defensively by Kenneth Durden, who came up from his corner spot to make the tackle. Durden, the transfer from South Florida.
Kodak Mutual Insurance replay. Stick's just assuming that he's going to beat the corner to the gap. So he's not even looking at a guy coming off to his right. Kind of sneaks in there, takes care of the ankle. He was waiting for that block to develop in front of him because the Bison did have a guy in there.
Third and two coming up from the 10. Frazier trying to move the pile, and he's going to be very close to a first down, and I think he's got enough at the 8. We'll see where the official spots it.
They're going to have to measure this one. That's my guess. We'll have to see the chains. Frazier trying to get a full head of steam. You see 66 Zach Johnson with the kick out. Frazier was second effort. His second effort last week was just tremendous, and here we'll see if his second effort got the extra length of a football he needed. But Frazier started about 9 yards deep to get a full head of steam heading toward the line.
Frazier again has had a couple of really big games, including one 2 weeks ago at Southern Illinois where he went off for 177 yards. And we'll see if it's got it. And he's going to be about the length of the football short. So what does Chris Kleiman do here on fourth and short at the 8-yard line?
He's going to keep the offense out there and go for it.
NDSU on fourth down this season, 8 of 12. NDSU will line up the big boys and try to gain about 2 feet.
Looks like Kuhnert is uncovered right now if he wants to sneak it.
Oh, and it looked like a couple of guys jumped, but who jumped first?
That almost always has to be the offense on a situation like this when you have that many people all move and the ball doesn't. Now you kick it.
So that will bring on the field goal unit. Yeah. Looks like the whole line move except Kuhnert. Kuhnert was the one guy on the O-line that did not snap the football when everybody else did move up front. So a 30-yard attempt coming up here for Cam Peterson, the true freshman from over there, straight away from 30. This one is up, has enough leg. And it is good. Cam Peterson knocks it through from 30. And North Dakota State is on the board, trailing 7-3. Tough sledding for North Dakota State here in the first half. They have had some positive plays. Bruce Anderson, a catch there.
It's just the opposite of what the Bison were hoping for today. The pass, the yardage, are going through the air. Real nice catch on that one. And here's the long play. Although the next one will be the long play down to Vra. But the Bison thought and felt that they need to run the ball just 35 yards so far on the ground.
LeCompte will put the boot to it 2 yards deep. That's Jody Webb going sideline to sideline. No room to go and taken down at the 13-yard line. Nice job on special teams. Jordan Champion, Matt Plank, Levi Jordheim all in there for NDSU.
Well, the big key here, you'll see it on the Kodak Mutual Insurance replay when you talked about, Brian, when he starts going sideways and the momentum upfield goes away, you know that you've won if you're the kickoff team.
There's a look at Jordan Champion, the senior from Avondale, Arizona.
His such a good tackler. Lead third on the team in tackles from that quarterback position. Plays a big part in the run stop as well. And then, of course, we just saw Champ there on special teams.
And they're really good in the slot. See, Youngstown State can muster. They have moved the football here in the first half.
At times, very well.
This one swung out, caught. Keeping his feet and then walloped by MJ Stubb.
And Harvin?
Yeah, I think it was Itavius Harvin making the catch.
Kind of a slow developing play and probably not option number one for Wells. You saw him have to do a little happy dance because the Bison coming from the edge. He gets past Chee Tucker, but then there's no way you were getting past Stumpf. MJ with a potential hit of the game candidate.
Stay tuned for our American Family Insurance hit of the game. There's a look at MJ Stumpf, the junior from Harvey. All that for a yard. Should bring up second and nine. Run again for the short side. Boy, NDSU had that one covered up as Ruiz was hit hard on the play by the true freshman, Robbie Grizzly. Loss of one. We'll bring up third and long.
Seemed like a little bit of a slower developing type of a play. The pitch out, able to get that shoulder pad on the front side. Really nice tackle just to be able to take the legs out. I know you're always taught to wrap up, but boy, when you're gunning for the legs to cut that runner, actually did it real well right there.
Four receiver single back here for Youngstown on third and 10. Play clock down to four, down to three. They get it off. Wells to throw. Wells flushed. Now Wells is going to have to run. And he's got a first down up to the 25. Not known for his legs or his feet, but he's able to scramble there for 11 yards and a first down.
Yeah, unlike a number of the quarterbacks in the conference where you almost have to account for the quarterback as a runner. Well, the Bison did not do that, didn't think they'd have to today, and Wells was able to pick up that big first down and third and long.
Bobcat game recap, North Dakota State. Five plays, 84 yards and 230, capped off by the Peterson field goal, but again, the plate of Zach Vrah was the one that really set that up. The Bison unable to capitalize in the red zone.
But when the offense is getting conversions on third and long, that really hurts the defense just staying out there so much longer.
Boy, Stubbs was bounced back. Nice job physically as Jordan Champion came up and knocked his blocker right back into Stubbs.
Well, we just talked about Champion being able to, you know, what he does physically on the edge, and this is about as good of example as you can see. There's no way Harvin's moving him. Champion's trying to reach around the guy and get in on the tackle himself, but he certainly slowed down Stubbs enough in order for Dempsey to come over and make it a loss on first down.
So second and 11 from the 24. Youngstown making calls, and on North Dakota State will change things up.
Seems a little bit more look out of Youngstown this week than they've shown the last couple of weeks.
Wells to throw. He's got time again across the middle, and another big hit by Pierre G. Tucker. That time as Jacob Wood made the reception. He gains about four.
Tight end on a delayed drag. And Tucker put him down hard. Across the face of DeLuca. Boy, you get in right underneath, right above the hip and underneath the ribs. That's a pretty good shot. Well, what do we got again?
Another third and long. And Youngstown is finding a way to continue to move the chains despite some of these third and long situations. And so far today, they are 3 of 5 on third down.
And the last conversion was 3rd and 10.
And the Bison have really not put a lot of pressure so far in the quarterback. Wells to throw, sidesteps one tackler and completes. That's to Williams, or excuse me, Darian Townsend makes the catch. And enough for a first down.
Well, Menard was coming and he comes on an inside. Kind of a wider split from Menard, beats the tackle. Really good job though from Wells of shuffling off to his left and keeping his eyes downfield. I mean, you hang this one on the quarterback, you just say that was well played.
So Darian Townsend from right here in Youngstown makes the catch. Well, it's just a sophomore. Youngstown State continuing to move the football.
Well, that defense for the Bison have been out for a here in the first half.
And somebody moved, and flag comes out. And they're going to get a false start here on the Penguins. Polini squad playing very well defensively and doing just enough offensively.
I crunched some numbers on Coach Polini. He is making $4,208 per day, 365 days a year for 46 months from Nebraska. Isn't that amazing? $128,000 a month Nebraska is paying him not to be there.
Wow.
That's a good gig.
That's not a bad gig. Takes a little pressure off the Penguins in the pay department as well. Ricky Davis back in the game. Jet sweep. A couple of broken tackles. And another big run for Youngstown State as Jody Webb slips through a crease. He's going to be very close to a first down, about 2 yards short, up to the 50.
Webb on the jet. You see Rivers motioning him through. Gets him in a pretty good timing. And that one-arm tackle he's able to beat is what is allowed the big first down run. Bison have been decent on first down right up until then. It's been third down that's been killing.
Davis is going to keep it again, and Davis showing some nifty feet. He's got a first down up to the 45.
Yeah, he's been pretty shifty too, hasn't he?
Take a look at our beautiful high definition broadcast brought to you by parentslead.org. Have conversations that matter with your children. Log on to parentslead.org for more information.
The Bison defense has just been out on the field for a long time here in the first half. On balance to the right.
Play action for Wells. Looking downfield. He's got a receiver one-on-one who's open. Incomplete. And he was open. Andrew Williams off his fingertips, incomplete.
That's a one-on-one with Smith. Makes a cut to the deep post. And the wind kind of holding that up just enough to allow Williams to try and make that catch back up to it.
Second and 10 coming up from the 45. And we are under 3 minutes to go here in the first half. It has been a quick moving first half. Each team has been able to move the ball consistently on offense. Jet sweep again. Boy, oh boy, Jody Webb off to the races inside the 20. Touchdown, Youngstown, 45 yards.
Success again of getting Webb in space, looking for the one-on-one matchup and then feeling that your guy is going to be able to beat it. Nice cut. There it was. Gets past Grimsley. Menard can't hold on to him. Off he goes. Touchdown.
Jody Webb has been the weapon of choice here for Youngstown State. And boy, is he responding. The junior from Toledo. His seventh rushing touchdown of the season.
It makes NDSU down in the red zone when the Bison had to kick the field goal, makes it hurt even more now that you give up the second touchdown.
Extra point is booted through by Zach Kennedy, and Youngstown State leads it 14-3 with 2:38 to go in the second quarter. Youngstown State leads it 14-3 with 2:38 to go here in the first half. North Dakota State on the season, averaging giving up about 100 yards a game on the ground. So far here in the first half, Youngstown State has 114. 45 of them on that touchdown run by Jody Webb as Kennedy will boot it deep. And taken by Bruce Anderson at the five. Anderson has a crease. There goes Anderson. Kennedy's got to stop him. And Anderson, a big return up to the 42-yard line. Big play on special teams for NDSU here with 2:29 to go.
Well, it's really nice to see Anderson getting back to being healthy. He missed some time with some bruised ribs, had some injured ribs, and tried to play with a big flak jacket on a couple weeks ago. But Anderson just is able to bust that big one, give the Bison something they needed, a spark.
10 plays and 6:02 for Youngstown as they're able to convert some big third downs, going 86 yards on that drive, capped off by the Jody Webb 45-yard touchdown run. So now the Bison will try to get something going here to try to get on the board before going into halftime. And they will have the football first coming out of the locker room. Play action. Stick as a flag comes in, and this one might be coming back anyway.
Yeah, this will be a hold.
So that will back up the Bison. I'm so used to saying Wentz back there for six games. I'm still not used to Stick being there.
No, Stick on the bootleg. Most of his effective passes, well, I guess he settled in a little bit from the pocket, but still he does most of his work on the run and on the move. And this was a hold behind the play. You got flankers.
So the Bison all the way back now in their own territory. First and 20 from the 48.
Not the way to start a drive after you have an explosive play, a near touchdown on your kickoff return. Everybody's pumped up, you're fired up, you're ready to go. Now it's first and 20.
They work out of the shotgun here on first down. Two receivers each side. Stick under pressure, and he is swallowed up back at the 40-yard line. And the bottom of the pile is who else? Derek Rivers, the all-time leading sack performer here at Youngstown State. And that will back up the Bison now to their own 40.
His eighth sack of the season. Rivers gets an inside move. He's going man up on flankers, gets that inside rush. No inside help. He's able to get to the quarterback. That time it was a pocket situation. The Bison had almost, they weren't stacked, but tandems on each side making multiple crosses on the out. So Stick needed more time for his receivers to get open, and there was no way he had that time.
Down to 1:20 left here in the first half. And Stick will take off and run with it and dart ahead back up to about the 47. And that will bring up third and very long, about 21.
Well, we talk about NDSU being solid on third down throughout the course of the year on defense, even though today hasn't quite been that way. Well, who's second in the conference in that category? It's the team out there in red on the third and long right now at 29%. So that's pretty standout stat coming into the game as well for Youngstown.
NDSU just 44 yards of rushing here in the first half. Jet sweep. Not going to be enough for a first down as Darius Shepherd is taken down after a gain of 8.
Lee Wright comes popping up and letting everyone know that he was in on that tackle.
And that might be the final play of the first half. Take a look at the NoDak Mutual Insurance replay.
Now Thompson also number one, I believe, in on it.
And that will be it for the first half. And Youngstown State playing with a lot here on Senior Day, and hold there's on. A lot on the line.
Hold on. The officials are waving like this thing's not over. Did Bison call the timeout, I think? Yep, so you see Coach Kleiman saying get back on the sidelines, telling Stick and the offense to stay back out there. Bison called the timeout.
Unless they're maybe planning on trying to throw something deep into the end zone in a couple seconds.
It's fourth down, so you really have nothing to lose. Why don't you try? Coach Pelini saying, hey, I thought this thing hit the zeros, but it didn't.
Well, we've seen crazy plays in college football this year, so why not give it a shot and see what happens?
I mean, it's fourth down anyway. It's not costing you, so I think Coach Kleiman's doing the right thing. Take a shot. I mean, it's different if you have 14-3 on the scoreboard, but no, it's the Penguins with the edge 14-3.
And now Youngstown will take a timeout to try to get their defense set for whatever NDSU is going to run here.
Well, the Bison showed an interesting formation. They had three receivers to the boundary, meaning the short side of the field. So that's something that NDSU, I don't believe, has shown yet today. And so you take the timeout and talk about it.
Bison fans little chilly, enjoying the sun a little bit as we take a look at the new seed fan cam. NDSU is going to have some work to do here in the final 30 minutes from the ice castle in Youngstown.
Well, Youngstown has had success in doing and taking away the number one thing the Bison wanted to do, and that's run the ball.
Stay tuned for a halftime report coming up in just a couple of minutes, including your halftime stats brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers.
Bison will probably motion out of it, but it is the same look. See the three receivers to the short side of the field, down at the bottom of your screen.
Stick is going to need some time. He's going to run out of time. And now he's going to launch to the end zone. All sorts of guys back there, and this one is incomplete. And that will do it for the first half as NDSU trails it by 11 here on the road. Beth Houle will catch up with head coach Chris Kleiman for the Bison here in just a moment. I'm sure coach is going to want to change some things up here in the second half, and Beth Houle is standing by with Chris.
Coach, you've got 30 minutes of football left here. What's the message in there at halftime?
Well, we're playing on our heels a little bit too much defensively. We missed a couple of easy fits that we have to adjust, and we've got to do a better job up front offensively. But there's still 30 minutes left. Our guys are playing hard. We'll find some answers in there.
Thanks so much, Coach. Guys?
As your PetroServe USA sideline report. Thank you very much, Beth. Stay tuned. The Proceed halftime report coming up in just a couple of moments as we throw it back to the studio in Fargo. You're watching KVLY and the NBC North Dakota Sports Network. The road team trailing 14-3, and the Penguins are pumped up. Stay tuned. Much more action to come from here at Stambaugh Stadium. Back at the Ice Castle in Youngstown, Ohio, the hometown Penguins have a 14-3 lead on North Dakota State and LT. The Bison only 42 rushing yards in that first half. I think they believe they could run the football more effectively than that, and they have not at this point.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if that is what is going to be tried to be established here in this opening drive. This first possession, I think, for NDSU is going to be a very important one to see kind of how the rest of this second half plays out. And the other thing on the flip side of that, Webb himself with over 100 total yards. So yeah, he's been the main big guy for Youngstown.
Yeah, 59 rushing yards for Jody Webb to go along with 46 receiving yards. Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Bruce Anderson from his own six.
Got a chance.
Anderson trying to get the edge, and Bruce Anderson cut down at the 32-yard line. Not as big as his last return, but good starting field position for North Dakota State.
Nice return, and it took a little bit too long to get to the edge. And I didn't catch the number of the Penguin player who just never gave up the outside. So that really made the difference between having it come back to the 32 or maybe having a chance to pop it.
North Dakota State will try to get something started here. Easton Stick in the first half, 5 of 7 for 109 yards, 66 of them coming on that long reception to Zach Fry.
I think the big stat, though, is first downs, 11 of them for Youngstown in that first half. The Bison defense, that through some of their own fault, stayed on that field way too long.
Ruzendowski, the motion man, did not have a catch in that first half. Back to power. Frazier has room this time, close to a first down, about 1 yard short, up to the 41.
Well, that's a play the Bison did not run a lot in the first half, but it is a play we all know that usually for NDSU to be successful, it has to work. There's the little pull there from Zach Johnson. He smashes his guy into the turf, and Frazier's able to cut right back off of that. 66 is Johnson. He buries the guy at the point of attack, and that allows almost first down yardage, a gain of 9.
Leroy Alexander came in there from his safety spot to make the tackle.
Very well done by the offensive line.
So second and one.
Same play.
Bruce Anderson bouncing off a couple of tacklers. He's got a first down up to the 44, gain of 3.
Same play, other side, Kelly the puller. Anderson ran into a little bit of trouble, but he kept his feet moving, felt for where the opening was, squirted off to his right, and got the first down.
So North Dakota State at least able to move the football here a little bit on their first couple of runs. Anderson will remain in the football game.
The thing that Anderson gives you, and we've seen Frazier, you know, with his big runs at Southern Illinois, but Anderson is more of a busted on any type of a play guy.
Play action for Easton Stick. Stick is going to take off and run with it. He's got some room to the outside. Easton Stick will step out of bounds just across midfield at the 48-yard line.
Certainly not a designed run. It became a run because of the way that the Youngstown played the three receivers, two on the side that Stick's looking at, one on the high side. Nodak Mutual Insurance Replay does the right thing. Do not force it. Get what you can. Exceptional yardage once again on first down, a gain of about 9, but the receivers were covered well. Stick realized that. Get what you can get, and he got 9.
So NDSU into Youngstown State territory, trailing by 11 here early in the second half. Stick, play action. He's going to chuck it deep. One-on-one coverage, and this one is caught at the 5-yard line. What an adjustment by Erzendowski. And the Bison in business, first and goal at the 5.
Well, you just got done saying that Erzendowski has not made the catch yet. Here he catches a big one all the way down to the 6-yard line, testing the outside vertical. That is where, in the passing game, Youngstown has been beat so far this year. It's been on the outside. The safeties have been pretty solid in the middle, but that time giving up a big play out on the outside, and the Bison doing what they need to do, and that is not only get in the red zone, but they need a touchdown.
And the Bison back in the Superior Inc. red zone, only been in there once today.
Must finish this drive.
Power play. Run inside, and Frazier squeaks through down to the 3. Jameel Smith makes the tackle.
First appeared that might have had a little bit, but I guess when you're at the 6, you get halfway to it, you'll take that on first down. But Nodak Mutual Insurance Replay, I thought this one first might pop free. Kelly with a little bit of a pull, but then Youngstown got 2 guys on Frazier. I thought if he was going just head man up, he might be able to pop off of one and get in.
High formation, everybody at the line of scrimmage here for NDSU.
3 tight ends out there.
Option. Stick is going to keep it. Easton Stick is just short of the end zone, down to about the 1/2-yard line. Looked like he was going to be able to dart in, and at the last moment was turned away.
See who flows and makes the play. It's Delavade with a man on him. Boy, that's a nice defensive play because Kelly was on him.
Bison go quick. Stick.
Boy, I thought he was in.
No signal from the officials. Nodak Mutual Insurance Replay.
They're waiting to see where the football is at the bottom of this pile. Not in.
Oh, boy. So now a 4th down and goal from right around the 6-inch line. I mean, that ball is right on the line. I think the Bison are going to go for it here.
Hey, got to get a touchdown. When you drive it this close, you're down. You did not score a touchdown in the first half. You must get this one in. Huge play coming for NDSU.
Chase Morlock checks in. Play clock down to 18. Here comes NDSU out of the huddle. 4th and goal. They need about 3 inches for a touchdown. Play clock down to 4. Stick gets it off. He's going to sneak. Touchdown!
He might only got 6 inches. You said he needed 3. He didn't get much more, but as soon as he broke the plane, he's in. Touchdown. That's what the Bison needed.
Big drive for North Dakota State coming out of the locker room as they march at 68 yards.
Trying to work off of Johnson's side, Haig's side. They're the guys on the left. Boy, Zach Johnson got a good block. They turned that nose. They turned the guy right there in the A-gap.
Well, nothing easy about getting that 6 points from inside the 5, but the Bison able to convert as Peterson boots through the extra point, and it's 14-10 with 10:40 to go here in the 3rd quarter. We'll take a break and be back with more from the Ice Castle after this. You're watching this high-definition broadcast on KBLI and the NBC North Dakota Sports Network, and it's brought to you by Parents Lead. Have conversations with your children that matter. Log on to parentslead.org for more information.
Impressive drive. The long play helps set up the touchdown.
Easton Snick, from about 3 inches away, gets in for the touchdown, the Bison's first of the day. Ben LeCompte will put the boot to it. Another Peterson farm seed kickoff. Bison special teams coverage units have done a great job so far here today. That return only to the 15-yard line. The return man, Tevin McCaster, rarely used tailback, a redshirt freshman. Taking a look now at our Bobcat game recap. Scoring drive, 7 plays, 420 and 68 yards. Of course, the big reception by Erzendowski. Got them down there.
Easton Stick finishes it officially. It'll be a 1 yard touchdown, even though we know he was he only needed a couple of inches.
So we'll see how the Youngstown State offense here responds. Jody Webb was the featured player in that first half.
Well, I was going to say, let's see how the Bison defense responds. I'll take it from the Bison defensive standpoint, because Bison needed a few more three and outs than what they had in that first half.
Swung out the flat, caught. Well, that play's been successful today, and Jody Webb has another first down, I believe, to the 25. Boy, he's been used and used a lot in a variety of ways.
Well, don't just say today. It's been an effective play all year long for Youngstown. Wells flips it out. The key thing is that Pierre G. Tucker got blocked. He was blocked on the play, couldn't get there to the point. There, Tucker's trailing the play because he got a real good block, and then Smith is trying to play off a block. Tucker gets in there too late for the pickup. First down.
Inside handoff. That's Ruiz. Gaining about 4 up to the 30. Ruiz not really used much in that first half.
He only gained 3 yards on 4 carries in the first half, so he just matched his first half production right there, maybe a yard more.
Second and 6 from the 29. Ruiz again, this time Ambrosius came down to get him. MJ Stumpf also in there to help make the tackle, and that will bring up a 3rd and 4. This is where North Dakota State is usually very good, but in the first half, Youngstown able to convert a lot of third downs. They were 4 of 6.
Yeah, Ruiz was getting up slow, not only slow, but he came off. Martin just comes to the sideline, waves his replacement in. But you're right, Brian, this was the critical down in that first half. Youngstown was able to stay on the field. Bison could not get off.
Ricky Davis in at quarterback, always a threat to run. Davis is going to run here. Davis stopped short of the first down, up to about the 28 and a half yard line. So that will likely bring up a punting situation here. NDSU gets a big stop. Nick DeLuca on the tackle.
Well, and Grimsley came down real hard too from his strong safety position. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, a simple quarterback power. He's trying to follow the pulling guy, and that is Grimsley, first guy there. Nice work by the freshman, Robbie Grimsley, to force the punt. That's what NDSU needed, I think, on this first possession as well. Even though, you know, Webb got the one first down, it's a pretty good defensive possession.
Nick Shealy has not punted much today, and he will boot this one into the wind. Perkins back at his own 20. Avoids one tackler. Perkins now cutting back against the grain. And Eric Perkins, a nice return up to the 27-yard line. 14-10, North Dakota State has the ball back. 8:02 to go on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Welcome back to the Ice Castle. Yeah, it is a little bit blizzardy out here. The wind howling up top.
Lance Dunn in at tailback now.
Stick's gonna keep it.
Looking for the drag.
Dick across the field to Shepard. Incomplete. Kenneth Durden right there on the coverage for NDSU, Youngstown, excuse me.
On the bootleg, Stick didn't have anything short. That was Bonnet. Didn't have Fra. He was the middle route at about 15 yards. And so he waited to try to hit the home run ball to Shepard down deep. Erzendowski won the one-on-one battle, but Shepard did not have an opportunity to try to win a 50-50 ball right there.
So that would bring up 2nd and 10.
I think, Brian, the Bison have an opportunity here on this particular drive to take a lot of the heart out of the Penguins if it ends up in the end zone.
That one thrown into the turf. Incomplete. Looking for Erzendowski, and that will bring up a 3rd and long. So a misfire there from Easton Stick.
trying to get Erzendowski on an isolation. Real good look on the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. That ball definitely hit the turf, so now you're third and 10.
See what Tim Polasek dials up here for the Bison offense.
Playbooks can get real thick until you get to third and 10. Then they get really skinny. There's not a lot of plays in the arsenal for this.
NDSU 2 of 7 on third down today. Normally 53%. Stick, straight drop. In the pocket. Drop it off. Going to be short of a first down as the reception is made by Dimitri Williams up at the 31, and that will bring up a punting situation.
Looked like the Bison tried that crossing route with the two tight ends that worked in the first half. It didn't work here because Bonnet was unable to kind of do a little bit of a pick. The linebacker stayed clean. Looked like Stick's first read wasn't there, and then he had to improvise.
So Ben LeCompte on for the punt. And Youngstown State holds defensively.
That was a big possession there for Youngstown defensively, no doubt.
This one angled towards the sideline. Will bounce at about the 33, and it continued to bounce inside the 25, out of bounds at the 23-yard line. And that's where Youngstown State will have it when we come back. It's 14-10 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. The Bison defense got a hold on the first Youngstown State drive. They'll try to do it again as the Penguins will start from their own 23. Play action, Wells to the air. Throw it outside and it's incomplete, looking for Jody Webb, and that one was just a bit short. We'll bring up second and 10.
Well, I like the play actually because you have Wells isolated against the linebacker Tucker in this particular instance. He held it too long. He just didn't throw the pass early enough. I think he might have been waiting to see if the safety was going to get beat on the deep route, and he wasn't. He was covered, and by that time Wells ran out of time to get it on the deep out.
Three receivers, single back. Youngstown State will change things up and look to the sideline. Then Jody Webb, the single back. Delayed handoff. One missed tackle. He is slippery. And Jody Webb into the clear again. And he's off to the races. Cuts back. Jody Webb. Touchdown, Youngstown.
The key to the long run. First guy there. Missed him. Tucker had a chance. Did not get a body on Webb. Then Webb picked up blockers. The further he ran, the more blockers he picked, and did a good job at about the 30 as well to stay patient to see if he would let his guy take care of the last man there. That was Smith. Smith was in the way enough from the defense. And off goes Webb. It's been his game today. I know it's senior day, but the junior's been doing the damage.
77 yards on the touchdown run. And oh boy, does Youngstown take the momentum back with that. Extra point is good from Kennedy, and Jody Webb today, 3 carries, 136 yards, and 2 touchdowns.
You'll see off to the right, right there. That's Pierre G. Tucker came in, tried to get the legs of Webb, and then missed it. Decent block on Allison. Smith is getting zigzag back and forth. His man gets in front of him. Really good downfield blocks. Most of the time, at this level, you do not bust a big running play without downfield blocks. Not only was it blocked very well at the point, the one man you had to beat, you beat, and then you got two critical blocks deep downfield.
Now the Penguins again lead by 11 with 7:02 to go here in the third quarter.
Going up again by the two-score difference too. Kind of takes a lot of that running, which the Bison have not been good at. You know they want to establish it, but it takes a lot of that away. Bison can't afford 7-minute drives right now. They're behind.
Kennedy will come on, the true freshman from Cardinal Mooney High School. That's a kickoff.
Same high school that Pelini went to.
That's right, head coach Bo Pelini. And there's a look at Bruce Anderson. Bumps it off a long 53-yard return in the first half. We'll have a chance here. Taken at the five. Another lane to the outside. Now cuts back. Bruce Anderson runs over the kicker and down to the 41. And a flag back at the 21.
Ooh, that is never a good sign.
Holding North Dakota State.
Just broke the big one.
Wipe it out and bring it back.
You can just see the, you know, look at Anderson. He's just like, oh, you're kidding me. And everyone on that special teams unit that did a great job of getting him all the way up to the 43. And this is going to start back inside your own inside your own 20.
There's a look at it. Watch him run over the kicker here. Kennedy only 160 pounds.
Well, I mean, give the kicker credit. He got in the way. He knew he was going to take one. He did take one. But that hanky back on the 21. Wow, what a change.
So the Bison, instead of having it at the 41 of Youngstown, will be backed up to their own 11. Oh boy. Penalties. Back to the ground game. Not much room for King Frazier. A yard or two up to the 18. Excuse me, the 13. Again, Lee Wright been very active today at his middle linebacker position, a converted safety from last year.
Here's a look at the touchdown once again.
From earlier
from
in the first
early,
half.
Yeah, there's where just Webb doing what he's doing, and this is the two play, and he takes it 77 yards. Boy, what a day for the young man. Webb is having a day. I mean, Youngstown needs this win in order to keep their playoff hopes alive, and they're gonna put themselves in a position to maybe get it.
This pass behind Urzendowski, and the football, I believe, is incomplete. So it was not live. We'll bring up third and long.
But Urzendowski played it as it was. You know, he can't give up on this thing because he does. He's not convinced it would be called maybe a lateral, and he bounced it out of bounds. It was back inside the five, but called incomplete. So that's a couple of passes from stick. You know, that, remember the one to the high side too that was into the feet of Urzendowski. This one flies up too high. So I don't know how many times you keep going to that play because your quarterback's not completing it.
Third and long. Youngstown faithful that is here trying to make as much noise as possible here on third and eight. Stick to throw. Stick under pressure and flushed. Now Stick's going to try to run for it. Easton Stick shortened the first down to the 19.
Wright came from behind and able to close down just enough to keep him short. When Stick first takes off, it looks like he might have an opportunity to get there, but check out, I guess that was number nine, excuse me, not number five. I thought it was number five, but that is Avery Moss, one of the defensive ends, trailing the play and showing some hustle. He was a guy who started his college career in Nebraska.
NDSU bringing a late player on here for the punt. The Bison, about a yard and a half short of the first down, is going to boot it away here. Compt will sail this one back to Stubbs, who calls for a fair catch at the 33, and Youngstown State will have the ball back with 5:13 to go, trailing by, leading, I should say, by 11.
Well, with the big plays that Youngstown has been able to get on the outside, you got to think that offense is just being big smiles getting out there. They've forced NDSU into some big time predicaments with those long touchdown plays.
Look at our North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. Which of the following is not a household use of soybeans? Boy, I hope toothpaste isn't. Maybe
Why?
It is. I don't
know. You eat soybeans. That's Why true. Could they not be used for toothpaste?
I don't know. Maybe we'll find out the answer.
Well, Bison need an answer here on defense.
Boy, do they ever. Stubbs the motion man. Davis is going to run, and now Davis is off to the races. Trey Dempsey's going to come in. A flag comes in. Two of them come in. So this may be coming back.
Now, there's going to be a hold on the guy, I didn't see who was the deep guy. Robbie Grimsley came up, tried to make the tackle. He missed, and we'll see a hold. See, there's Grimsley, overran the fit, and there's DeLuca is the guy who got held. Nice replay, guys. Brought to you by Nodak Mutual Insurance.
So that will back up and negate the run from Ricky Davis.
Yeah, that was a tackle. It wasn't just a hold. That was a tackle by the offense. Here it is again. Just watch number 49. That's DeLuca. He's held. He's held. He's being driven. Now he's tackled.
So bring it back for a first and 9 at the 35. And Hunter Wells will check back in. Bo Pelini having, looks like, a pleasant conversation with the official on the sidelines.
That's the face that Nebraska fans got to see a lot over the last 7 years.
And off to Ruiz. Ruiz, no room to maneuver. Right at the line of scrimmage, met by a trio of Bison. Nick DeLuca in there with Grant Morgan and Robbie Grimsley. Let's take a look now at the answer to your North Dakota Soybean Council trivia question. Which of the following is not a household use of soybeans? The answer is toothpaste.
Oh, there you go.
Hey, boom. 1 for 8 in the season. Second and 9 from the 35. Wells remains in the game. And off outside, a crease. And he's still on his feet as Ruiz, and the Bison defense dragging him finally down inside their own territory at the 49. Grimsley in on that tackle along with Greg Menard.
Well, Ruiz came off earlier, kind of a little hobbled, a little slow, but there he just kept driving and kept driving, and now he's just carrying people across midfield. Well, that was a nice hard run.
The one thing, talking to some of the folks at Youngstown last week, was that Bo Pelini has ramped up the physicality in November, where Eric Wolford, the former coach, really ramped it down. And they thought that's really been an important aspect here for the Penguins. Davis will run again. Not room that time. Bison had that one fitted up pretty well. MJ Stump got in there with DeLuca and Grimsley. Gain of maybe a yard.
Yeah, Menard was also in on that play.
Boy, the Bison defense really has to have a stop here.
But you know, like, second and long, third and long, just hasn't seemed to be too big of an issue for the Penguins today, and that is not a good sign for that Bison defense.
Youngstown, 330 total yards, 226 of those on the ground. And off again, more room to the outside, and there goes another one of those backs for Youngstown inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. Damon Hines, first carry today, and he's got Youngstown in business.
Blocked well.
Oh, he's pushed out of bounds. Excuse me, at the 27. That's where they're going to mark him out of bounds. Not at the 5.
Left.
Boy, that was close.
Right there. There it was. Left foot did hit. Boy, he squirted through there and kept going. There's a look at it. You saw him hit that big white border. Guys on the field with the cameras on their shoulders. That's not an easy thing to do all day, but they were right on it.
Another big gain on the ground. And boy, North Dakota State has given up some big runs. Here's a look at it. They may take a look at this one.
Someone called the timeout. And it was Youngstown that called the timeout.
2:14 to go here in the third quarter. Matt Entz trying to fire up his defense. It looks like the Bison have had opportunities, LT. They just missed some tackles. Jamar Kane also down there, the defensive ends coach.
Yeah, I mean, it's twofold. A, you missed it, and B, Webb and those guys have been running so hard, they haven't you know, they've made you miss too. You know, you run through arm tackles. So it's whenever you see that, obviously it's a little bit of both. And you know, if you're a Bison fan and you've watched them all year, you've got to be as surprised as we are, because we've watched them all year, that that has been happening over and over today.
Jody Webb split out to the high side of the screen. He's in the slot there.
Right there at number on the 30-yard line.
He's been dangerous lining up in that area. Ricky Davis in the game at quarterback.
Can't imagine he's going to pass it.
There goes Webb in motion. Davis is going to keep it. Davis taken down for a 1-yard loss. MJ Stumpf makes the stop.
That's a super job by Stumpf. He just widened out and took the blow from the blocker. The blocker actually looked like he got into his chest. Stayed upright, kept his feet where he needed to do, slide past that off to his right, make the read. That's just an excellent individual effort there from MJ Stumpf. The Bison need more of that.
Hunter Wells back in at quarterback. Now 1-2 to go in the third quarter. Late handoff to Webb, slips out of another tackle, and finally taken down from behind. Pierre G. Tucker got in there with Greg Menard.
Well, Tucker is the only linebacker on that play that did not blitz. NDSU was blitzing the run, and so Webb was able to sneak through, and Tucker with an important tackle to make it third and long. Here comes both Stumpf, 41, DeLuca, 49, and that's what we're talking about. DeLuca just doesn't miss very often. Well, hey, you got to credit the runner on a situation like that. He made him miss, and then Tucker got the important tackle, third and 10.
Wells to throw. Wells looking for Stubbs. Incomplete, just overthrown. Trey Dempsey on the coverage for North Dakota State.
Pretty well covered, and it looks like Stubbs flattened that route out more than his quarterback thought. Stubbs will take it more toward the 5-yard line. His quarterback throws it more toward the flag into the corner of the end zone.
So Thomas Kennedy will come on for a 44-yard field goal attempt. Kennedy, 6-8 from 40-plus.
And the
17
wind,
of 21.
The wind, Ryan, has gone down quite a bit, too, just judging by the big flag. So this, in the first half, might not have been attempted.
Kennedy sends it up. Looks good. And it is. The true freshman bangs it through from 44. And Youngstown State extends the lead to 24-10 with 39 seconds left here in the third quarter.
You keep the Bison offense off the field as long as Youngstown did there, and you get points out of it. That's a win-win.
We talk about time of possession and how North Dakota State has been so good in that area. About 37 and a half minutes a game so far today. Youngstown State winning that battle, 22-47 to 21-34.
To be honest, I would have guessed that it was higher than that. It seems like it's been more than that, but there's a lot of big plays in there on the offense, too, that shorten some of those drives.
247 rush yards.
But just look at Grimsley. I mean, he's tired. He's a tired young man right there. Look at C.J. Smith. You know, he looks tired. Allison was out there. Jalen, those guys, they've been battled today.
And Youngstown State has come out physically. And as you mentioned, LT, give credit to the running backs. They have run hard and made some guys miss.
They've made them miss.
Take a look at the Bobcat game recap. Another 4-minute plus drive for Youngstown. 9 plays, 434, a 66-yard drive, resulting in a 44-yard field goal by Kennedy. This one boomed. Looks like it may head out of bounds. And it will. So North Dakota State will have pretty good field position up to the 35. Well, if you're the Bison, you almost have to have a score now, don't you?
Boy, sure would. Yeah. If you're going to give up, you know, 5 minutes or 5 to 7 minutes on the clock every time that you give the ball back, that shortens that game a lot for Coach Pelini's team. Well, the question we had right off the top of the show, why are these guys, the guys that you've seen today be so productive, why are they a game over 500 and 3-3 in the Valley? Nobody knew the answer because they were so talented. Well, that talent has certainly dominated the first three quarters.
Bruce Anderson in the game now at tailback. Easton Stick's going to keep it. Easton taken down by Nate Dorch after a gain of one.
Now, the key there is that Braw has to be able to keep him out of the play. And he couldn't do it. Stick probably was a little wider than he wanted. He had a little bit of a lead. That was a similar look to that play down in Southern Illinois that worked so well with that running back lead when Morlock was able to get out in front of it. But Stick probably had to belly a little bit too far out, and Braw's block became not one. Not going to get the playoff.
Nope. That'll be the end of the third quarter. North Dakota State has some work to do if they want to come back in this football game today. 24-10, they trail it on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. And hey, it's the fourth quarter, so raise your four to get the 4 for 4 from PetroServe USA. A pizza, two cookies, and a drink at all 24 PetroServe USA locations. We'll be back with the fourth quarter coming up after this. You're watching KVOI and NBC North Dakota Sports. Dakota State, 2nd and 9 from the 36, trailing by 14. Moody, the motion man. Hand off. Frazier has room. Bruce Anderson, down the sidelines. And the speedy freshman inside the 10, down to the 7.
Boy, the Bison needed something positive to happen, and they just got it. Bruce Anderson on a similar look. You would have swore he had a red jersey on, and he wore number 20. That's the way it's gone today. But, yeah, great job. There's Morlock got a cut. Morlock cuts down the corner. And then Wright comes all the way back and just barely trips up Anderson. He almost gets it in, but he's down to the 8-yard line. Boy, a quick score here is exactly what NDSU needs.
57 yards on that run from Bruce Anderson. And the first time, really,
let's go.
That NDSU has broken the big run today as NDSU is back in the Superior Inc. red zone. Now Beth Poole is on the sidelines for us and has a PetroServe USA sideline report. Beth.
The difference there, guys, is we're seeing NDSU make Youngstown State a little bit uncomfortable. It's the first time really this game we've seen that happen. I was just over on the Penguin sideline where everything was positive. Everyone was working well, and the difference this season has been that it hasn't been comfortable on a Penguin sideline. There's been tumultuous energy between Bo Pelini and his offense. They're getting too comfortable, and this Penguin offense is finding its stride. NDSU needs to find a way to make that Youngstown State offense uncomfortable if they want to turn the tide in this football game, and the offense just did their part to start pushing in that direction.
Beth, thank you very much, and they are taking a look at it, I think, upstairs to see if Bruce stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, Pelini was pretty convinced that Anderson stepped out of bounds. He called the timeout, requested the opportunity to look at it again, and so they're going to look at it again. And we saw that situation in, you know, I think it was last week where, you know, if he's right, then he won't be charged with the timeout. I don't think he went out. They're looking at his right foot back there.
Certainly not from that angle that we have, unless it was before that.
There he's charged with the timeout. The play was
upheld.
And again, we're not sure if the officials are looking at our telecast or the home team's telecast. Our cameras, because of where we are, see it much better on our side. And he's in. I think,
yeah, he's in.
That right foot
there.
is not on the white. So he's in. Cost plenty of timeout.
So now Youngstown down to one timeout here in the fourth quarter.
But also the timeout, what it does, it kind of slows NDSU down again. Weisenberg just wanting to go after that big play. Let's jam it into the end zone.
First and goal from the 7. Frazier up the middle. King Frazier. Touchdown. Bison. Big answer. And quickly.
Last pitcher perfect blocking on the power play. And those linebackers from Youngstown that have been all over the place, not on this particular play. They were blown out of there. Joe Haig with the key block to get Anderson into the end zone.
So North Dakota State answers in a hurry and gets a touchdown as Peterson will knock through the extra point. And with 14:22 to go, North Dakota State is within 7 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Has not been easy sledding for that North Dakota State running game. King Frazier, 12 carries, 43 yards. But that last run was a big one. Ended up in a touchdown, 7 yards out. As you take a look at the Bobcat game recap, and that only took the Bison 1:06 to go 65 yards in just 3 plays. Compt will kick it off to Webb at his own 1. Webb stumbles and falls down at the 14-yard line. Kick returns have been an issue for Youngstown today.
I think that was Dan Marlette that busted through 2 guys to get himself in position. Webb hobbling there?
Looks like he got him a little bit slowly, and he wants out of the football game. And that's a guy that's certainly been big today for Youngstown in terms of what they've been able to do. And if he comes out, that takes away a little bit from what they can do.
Well, the Bison offense did what it needed. That was a quick strike to get 1 touchdown down. Now it's up to the defense. The defense has had problems today. We know that. But if the Bison can stop here, that would change the complexion of this early fourth quarter.
Still plenty of time, 14:18 to go in the football game. Play action. Wells is going to air it out. And this one is batted away by C.J. Smith. Williams, the intended target. Youngstown taking a shot there downfield.
Yeah, it's kind of a long fade, which is somewhat of an odd place on the field to do it. But you know it's a safe play. You're giving Williams, one of your seniors, top receivers, a chance to make the 50-50 catch. But the ball just hung there enough that Smith was able to get back relatively easily.
2nd and 10 from the 14.
The incompletion on 1st down, does that force you to go to the throw again?
Nope. Ruiz will get the carry. He squirts through a hole. Bison eventually tackle him after a gain of 4 at the 18. Jody Webb remains out of the football game. Aaron Steinle in to help make that tackle on Ruiz. And an important 3rd down here for Youngstown State. The Penguins today 4 of 8.
Now Steidel will slide off, and I think you're pointing because Webb came back in. And it's Rivers, too, at quarterback on the 3rd down play.
Yeah, Davis.
Or Davis, yeah.
Watch out for quarterback run here. Motion man. Davis is going to throw it under pressure downfield to Stubbs. And he just overthrew him, and Davis took a big shot on the play. And Stubbs had a step, but it was overthrown by just a couple of yards.
Well, YSU gambles because they know that Davis is the running quarterback. The safeties have to honor that. You're trying to beat Grimsley deep. There you see Grimsley trying to get back there. He has kind of split the difference between the safeties with Dempsey there, and there's no way that he could get the pass over the top and deep enough to make that connection.
So the defense gets a 3-and-out from Youngstown and should have pretty decent field position here. Eric Perkins back to take the punt from Sheely at his own 40. And this is kind of a wobbler. Oh, boy. Out of bounds, and the Bison are going to have great field position inside Youngstown State territory all the way down to the 43-yard line. And we'll take a timeout and be back. Bison, good field position, trailing by 7. North Dakota State has good field position at the 42-yard line, trailing by 7 with 13:17 to go in the football game. Back to the ground game. It's Frazier pushing the pile ahead. Determined run there by Frazier, who's got close to 6. All the way down to the 36.
A Well, that was what the Bison were hoping to see in the first half, just taking the pile with your big offensive line and moving it. There the Bison did that. Really nice job on first down, picking up that 6 yards. The thing that the quick strike does in that, you know, we're still only a couple of minutes into the fourth quarter. That quick touchdown helps set things up for NDSU. They do not have to be in a hurry despite trailing.
Shepard motions to the bottom of the screen. And he will get, that's Urzendowski that makes the catch, and he's taken down. Nice open field tackle as Dortch works off a tackle, and Urzendowski's going to be very close to a first down, maybe a yard short up to a 33.
Well, it's been a play that's been ineffective simply because Stick has missed Urzendowski. This time, it's a little bit out in front of him. R.J. Master reach and make the catch. And it's third and one.
Third downs have not been easy for NDSU today. 2 of 9. They need a yard here to convert and move the chains. Stick will operate out of the shotgun. Stick is going to throw. Stick, incomplete. And the Bison electing to throw the football there on third down. And that will bring up a very interesting play call here for Tim Polasek on 4th and 1.
You pass it here on the third down, trying to catch Youngstown napping a little bit. You certainly see Morlock is covered. And you see Rivers, the number one sack man, trying to run down your quarterback. You knew it was 4 down of territory anyway. 2 plays to get the yard. Gambled a little bit maybe to try to hit something big downfield that wasn't there. Now you force your hand. You need this yard.
And a flag. Oh, boy. Who is this on? Oh, it's on Youngstown. This is going to be an automatic first down for the Bison.
12 men. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Oh, boy. On a huge fourth down play, Youngstown caught with too many men on the field, and that will be a first down for the Bison inside the 30.
They just give them to him.
Yeah, that's 12 right there.
I thought I counted right. I counted fast, but I counted twice before I said 12 guys out there, but they're there.
Oh, boy, look at Bo Pelini. He is all over the white hat.
I don't know, it seems like they take a lot from him. He yells a lot, he always, but sorry, Bo, check the tape. It was there.
Well, I think he was wondering if he would still have time to substitute after NDSU made some personnel changes. So the Bison in business with under 12 to go.
Shifting strong side to the left, motion away from it again.
Elias is the man in motion there. And this is Frazier trying to put a shake on, and he got back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. Eventually bumped down on the play by Dortch. And also in there, Eric Thompson.
Stretch play, trying to see what you can get to the outside. And it is not there. Take Frazier's momentum away. First guy in. The first guy in, I think, was Smith.
And there's a look at Eric Thompson. Plays more of a linebacker role, kind of a hybrid. Stick is going to keep. Stick dives ahead to about the 23. Picks up 6. We'll bring up another third down in about 5.
That was Dortch on that play once again, and he's going to come off. Number 8, you see him coming off the field right there, but he's the guy that Stick's going one-on-one against, and he didn't miss.
Boy, third down's always big, but so big here, trailing by 7.
Coach Kleiman hoping he doesn't have to make a difficult decision. He wants to see the first down.
Stick going to drop back and throw it. Downfield for a receiver. Incomplete. Just overthrew his intended target on the play, R.J. Urzendowski. And that will bring on the field goal unit for the Bison.
Similar look worked last week. You try to freeze everyone at the line. Think quarterback run. He pulls it back in just out of the reach. Even if Berzandowski was able to make one of those one-handed catches, I don't think he gets down, does he? Yeah, probably not. Not after it's tipped up into the air.
So Peterson will attempt a 40-yard field goal here to get the Bison closer. Puts the toe to it, and Peterson knocks it through from 40. And the Bison within four at 24-20 with 9:57 to go. Back with more from Stambaugh Stadium. After this, you're watching KBOI and NBC North Dakota Sports. Ben LeCompte on once again here for North Dakota State as we are just under the 10-minute mark to go, and the Bison trail it by four. LeCompte, another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. This will be a touchback, and the Penguins will start on their own 25-yard line. Beth Houle on the sidelines for us as a PetroServe USA sideline report. Beth.
Hey, guys, the Missouri Valley continuing to be unpredictable this weekend as South Dakota State just scores a touchdown in the fourth quarter. They now trail South Dakota 20-17. Again, that one in the fourth quarter. Well, Illinois State trails Southern Illinois 21-14. That one at halftime in this crazy Missouri Valley Conference.
Boy, oh boy, is it crazy.
The top three teams are all behind. Well, Youngstown, I think, helped NDSU with that first incompletion on the pass. We'll see if they try to keep it on the ground or go through the air again.
On the ground. Webb met that time by DeLuca right at the line of scrimmage. No gain.
Well, I don't know if it's because Webb came off slow after not this kickoff, the kickoff before, but he didn't seem to look like he was in too big of a hurry to try to make a move.
Or
try
Ruiz, excuse me.
Ruiz, okay, that explains it, because DeLuca was on him and on him hard. That's squared up and about as good as you can tackle a guy.
Well, we're doing our best, folks, but
we're a long ways away.
We'd be better off being on a blimp. Will throw. Wells has time, drops it off, and short hops Ruiz. And another third and long coming up.
Well, there's not many where you just look at the quarterback and go, that was a terrible pass, but there was an instance of that was a terrible pass. It's been an effective play all year long for Youngstown, and in this game again today, just a little dump out into the flat and let your running back try to make somebody miss.
And the Penguins convert here on third and long. They hit a couple of big ones in the first half.
Well, the back judge is the one who came in with the whistle. Well, they're going to reset the play clock. That's what.
Hey, folks, like this is us up here.
We're a long way.
We're on the elements. We're bundled up, and you can see just how far away we actually are from the game action up here in Stambaugh Stadium.
This is the highest. We're on top of the tallest structure in Youngstown.
That's right.
We can't get any further away from the field. We're down.
Wells under pressure, looking deep. Caught.
No.
Dropped.
Harvin.
Oh boy, Itavius Harvin had it in his hands and could not hang on.
Oh boy, he just had an opportunity there to really put the pressure on the Bison. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. This is one of Wells's better passes all day long. Right after he just threw a terrible one, wow, he dropped it in the breadbasket and dropped. Well, that's exactly what Harvin just did. Wow. Big break for the Bison.
Oh boy.
Big.
So North Dakota State will get the football back, and they only took about 57.
Another
oh boy, that's another wobbler. Doesn't end up too bad, down to about the 40-yard line, but North Dakota State again will have good field position. It looks like Sheely comes up a little bit lame as he limps to the sideline.
Last drive resulted in, let's see if we can, oh, it's off his toe. He just mishit it so bad he hurt himself.
It didn't end up as bad as it could have. He's only up about traveling 35 yards or so.
remember in an NFL game with the Giants once I saw the punter miss the ball. It's the only time I've ever seen the punter just drop it and miss it. Yeah, he's hurt.
North Dakota State has not led in this football game, but they have a chance here to make some noise. Frazier again gets the call. Frazier will take on a tackler and drive to about the 38-yard line, gain of two.
Boy, Chase Morlock threw a real nice block on Eric Thompson, and Thompson is still down. I thought if Frazier could have got to the edge a little bit earlier, he might have been able to take advantage of that nice block, but it was a good job by Youngstown and able to string that play out far enough to let the sideline be number one. There's Morlock, comes in, cuts him down low, takes him out of the play. And that's Smith again, who has played a reserve role. Smith's not even on the two deep, I don't think.
This game brought to you in high definition on KVLY and the NBC North Dakota Sports Network by Speak Volumes. Reminding you that one drink isn't always just one drink. Log on to speakvolumes.nd.gov for more information.
No, I'm sorry, I misspoke. Jamal Smith is in there as the safety.
Eric Thompson, again, that kind of that hybrid linebacker slash defensive back. And you've certainly seen the athleticism. Getting to the edge on this Youngstown State defense has not been easy. Paul Pelini earlier this week was asked, is this the most talented team you've played? He said, I don't know if they're any more talented, but they are so committed to what they do, and they do what they do well. There's a strong culture, and they believe in what they do there. So that's half the battle sometimes, just getting the kids to believe in your system and what you do.
Well, you can't say that the Penguins didn't believe in what their system in that first half, because they took NDSU away from what it does and does well, and that is run the football. That's why we're staring at the score we're staring at right now and in the position we are with 8:40 to go in this fourth quarter.
Back to the ground game. Lance Dunn falls ahead for 2 yards, maybe three, up to the 45, and that will bring up another big third down.
Yeah, Croma, the big defensive tackle, senior from Trenton on senior day, making that play. For the Bison at third and what far? Five? Between five and six.
Bison 2 of 11 on third down. Very uncharacteristic of this Bison squad. Big one here. Third and 5 from the 45. Stick will throw. Stick has time. And misfires to Zach Fraw. Incomplete. And Youngstown State holds with 7:51 to go.
Brock came in motion. He was the furthest guy left in the formation, and then he ends up trying to work all the way across the field. You'll see him come in there, right there. He doesn't get a clean break and cannot get any separation. And Stick, of course, has a couple of guys in red jerseys staring at him, and he didn't have a very good look on that one, and it was thrown behind.
So NDSU misses an opportunity there with pretty good field position, and Ben LeCompte will come on to punt once again. Youngstown State running a player on late. Compt will spin this one downfield, bounces and taken at about the 15-yard line. That was taken by Andre Stubbs. We'll see if the Bison defense can come up with another stop here on Youngstown. 2-3 and outs.
Last two
possessions. Be sure to stay tuned for the end of the game for the American Family Insurance hit of the game. Have a couple of good candidates. MJ Stumpf had a big one in the first half.
Well, on first down, the last two times that Youngstown has had the ball, that's been the decider. That's been the main reason it's been the three and outs. Bison were solid on first down.
Ricky Davis in the football game. Davis has had some success running the football today. He's 0-3 throwing, but has run 9 times for 54 yards. And he will run here. Stopped on the play by Trey Dempsey after a gain of 3.
Dempsey reading the option. He's first guy there, taking the quarterback, trying to force the pitch. Oh, don't think Davis is too anxious to try to pitch that thing anyway, especially in this position on the field.
Second and seven. Davis again will run, wrapped up at the 20-yard line.
Allison, first guy there. DeLuca, second guy there.
Greg Menard, third guy there. They wanted a face mask. Do not get the call, and another big third down, third and four. Davis will remain in the game.
Yeah, run is certainly still big time in the play calling options right here, dictated mostly by probably who's out there as quarterback. They've run quarterback power out of this, but there goes Webb.
Webb cut down. What a play by Greg Menard. Lots of five. Back to the 15.
Well, Webb's done a lot of damage on the edge. How do you take that away? Don't let him get there. This will come right at you. Menard blasts upfield and gets just enough of Webb to take him off his feet. Another three and out. The Bison defense has done it here in the fourth quarter.
They have responded, and we'll see if the offense, with about 5.5 minutes to go, can move it down the field.
Quite a bit of time, all three timeouts as well, Coach Kleiman has to work with. Last two punts have been poor.
Another wobbler. Takes a Youngstown State bounce inside the 50 down to the 46. But again, North Dakota State will have pretty good field position with 5:26 to go. Bo Pelini hoping his defense can hang on for one more possession. We're getting down to the nitty gritty here.
Last couple of times, you know, the Bison have had, you kind of look at it offensively and say, yeah, they still got time. You still got time. You can get three and out from your defense. Well, we're getting to that point of the game where you don't want an empty possession anymore.
Zendowski in motion. Back to the power game. This is Frazier. Frazier has one player to beat. He throws him down, and Frazier across midfield to about the 48-yard line. How about that stiff arm for the junior?
Well, Jamel Smith has been pretty solid coming up and bringing those Bison backs down. This time, Frazier just says, get out of my way. Gorgeous job on the stiff arm. Gets up into the head, neck, throws him away, and then physically finishes it.
Frazier out of the game. Lance Dunn in the game. Is that Anderson?
Can't tell. I think it's Anderson.
Anderson's got speed. Anderson gets a block. And he's got a first down to the 43.
Well, you're hoping to pop it as Anderson has, but the big thing there is get that first down. Clock stops. You get to regroup in the huddle. Now it resets and goes. The clock, that is.
Bison will change personnel as we're down to 4.5 to go.
Man on both outside. So if Bison decide to pass, it looks like press man coverage on both receivers.
Play action. One-on-one, looking downfield, jump ball, and incomplete. Erzendowski, the intended target once again, and that ball a little bit too far for him to make a play on it.
The wind has gone down, but the wind is still blowing to that sideline, so that ball got up in the air and kind of faded a little bit and didn't get an opportunity to make a play on it inbounds. There's the press coverage, so it's man up. He does fight for it. They call them 50-50 balls, but not a chance to catch it because they weren't on the field.
So NDSU on second and 10 from the 43.
I like taking the shot, though, because you're still figuring three plays to get the first.
King Frazier, not much that time. Maybe a yard to the 42. A couple of Youngstown State Penguins came flying in to make the stop. Lee Wright.
I'm not certain, but I think Rivers was first guy there, busting down from his left defensive end.
Third down has been a nemesis for NDSU. Second, third down conversion was last half. 2 of 12 so far today. Heisen will spread it out. 10 on the play clock.
Three receivers to the wide side to the field. Now Ilias will come in motion.
Stick will throw. Stick to the outside, and another big catch by Jeff Ilias into coverage. He's got a first down at the 26.
Wow, I thought Stick was going to go to the inside guy to draw because his man kind of played off, but no, he's looking at Ilias, and he puts it right on that backside. Puts it hard. It wasn't really a fade, but he throws it to that back shoulder. Ilias makes the play on it. And the first down that the Bison desperately need. Clock inside of three.
That is the first third down conversion this half. One under three to go. Bison need a touchdown. Rosendowski, the motion man. Anderson tiptoes through the hole. Gets 3 yards up to about the 22.
Running the power. But one of the linebackers, I think it was Delevate, was the guy that kind of plugged things up and forced the runner to leave his feet.
Second and 7. Now down towards 2 minutes to go.
Press coverage again on the wide side. Safety sucking in.
Rosendowski again will go in motion. Inside handoff again to Frazier. Lunges ahead to about the 17. Will be 2 yards short of a first down.
Same guy there to make the tackle again. Delevate, a freshman linebacker. Made back-to-back stops.
Bison the superior in red zone. Where they got to have a touchdown this time. Under 2 minutes to go. Obviously two down territory here for the Bison. Got to find a way to get 3 yards in the next two plays to keep the chains moving. On at the motion man again.
Oh, penalty.
No, they're going to let it go. Flips it up. Incomplete. And I don't know what happened.
That was a late flag.
Oh, boy.
On the high side, right where the pass was intended.
Oh, boy. Kenneth Durden and Bo Pelini is about to blow the top off his head. Flag came in late, and if this is on Youngstown, that will put the Bison inside the 10. And it looked like some players jumped.
It looked like, to me, the left side of the offensive line popped out a hair early. That wasn't called. The play continued. You threw a fade. Then that pass seemed a little bit high as well. I know Youngstown's probably going to say that's uncatchable. Oh, boy.
Wow.
What a call.
Now, the ball might have been snapped, and it looked like Pick Stick almost had to pick it up off the turf. Nate Moody was the intended target. And Durden was whistled for the pass interference.
Wow.
That is a big call at this stage of the game.
And an extremely tough one to take.
Youngstown
State. I mean, the Bison got the benefit, but that's a tough call against him. Now NDSU is inside the 10.
First and goal at the 6. Back to power. Frazier again lowers the head to the 4.
The reason that you go back to that previous play, the ball was snapped earlier. Stick wasn't ready for it, so it seemed like the ball came up to him before the actual snap count. He gathers it. That's why it looked weird. The ball was in play. It just looked like the left side moved early, but the ball was already in play, and then the Bison get the huge call on the pass interference.
Under 50 seconds to go. Here it is. Watch. The snap came, and then Stick just had to throw it up. Wow. No Doubt Mutual Insurance replay. Stick on the quarterback keeper. Touchdown. Yeah.
Designed run by the quarterback. C's kind of parted on the right side. He'll come right at you. Stick. Great job of the block. And he beats the man to the inside, beat the safety. That's the designed run. On a quarterback run, you have to beat the safety, and that's what Stick does right here. Great job to get right out of the way. Touchdown. Bison take the lead.
Peterson now for the extra point. It's down, it's up, and it's good. With 35 seconds to go, North Dakota State has their first lead of the football game.
On that drive, obviously, Brian, the Bison did not panic, did not use a timeout. And that's why there's only 35 seconds left.
Take a look at the new seed fan cam, and the Bison faithful have been waiting all day for their team to come back. Has come back all the way, scoring 17 unanswered to take a 27-24 lead.
And once again, the Pelini and the white hat are going at it. I mean, I wouldn't take it. He's been in his ear all game long. He's stomping out on the field. After a while, you give him the flag, and then tell him to shut up.
Well, you feel for Youngstown to some degree, because this is their season on the line here. Beth Hula, that's a Petrol Surf USA sideline report. Beth.
Color from down here on the sideline. I know you guys can see Bo, who was just giving it to the white hat. One of the sideline judges just went and talked to the officers to make sure that they've got an escort out of here, as fans along the sideline from the stands in the end zone are really starting to give it to them.
Boy, oh boy.
If Pelini wants to get mad at anyone, it's the guy who threw the flag on the other side of the field on the pass interference play.
Again, Youngstown just needs a field goal to at least send it to overtime, but only 35 seconds to work with.
Well, a pair of dangerous returners back there. That right now must be Youngstown's hope, and obviously the Bison on special teams kick coverage. Trying to come up big.
This guy is dangerous. The Bison hem him in. Jody Webb at the 30.
Borden Anderson in on the tackle. Two timeouts left for Youngstown.
Take a look at our Bobcats game recap. Boy, Bo is still yelling at the officials.
What do you got to do to earn it?
10 plays, 451. 54-yard drive, and Easton Stick punches it in. We still got 29 seconds to go. Youngstown has shown how dangerous they can be. Hunter Wells back in the game.
There, he finally got one. Pelini walked close enough to the lineman that he touched the head linesman. They bumped. He finally got one.
That's going to be a 15-yard penalty on Bo Pelini, and that's going to back up his team all the way to the 15.
Now, I'm serious. It's about time he got one. And he finally made contact. He got enough of yelling and screaming to get one, but he touched the lineman. It was just a brief little touch, but he walked past him on purpose, touched him, he threw the flag.
Look, I know it's a long shot. You'd have to get 30, 35, 40 yards, but now you're making your team go even further by setting him back. The Bison, I think, content to just rush three and play coverage. And this one behind his intended target. Stubbs wasn't even looking for the football, second down.
One thing Coach Entz told us on Thursday this week, that in coverage this year, Wells has been not as proficient. Coverage meaning rushing fewer players and using more to cover. Obviously, with the scoreboard situation, 25 seconds left, and you're trying to, you know, protect the lead and everything. But so it's a situation where the Bison, I think, will rush three once again. Get as many people in coverage as you can.
25 seconds to go. Second and long. They got to get the 40 just for a first down. Wells, time, flushed. Fires across the middle. Stubbs cannot make the catch. It was a little bit high and off his fingertips. And now third down with 20 seconds to go.
Not that high, though. You almost expect that he should pull this one down. But even if he makes that catch, he's still 10 yards short. Here's your Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Wells has to slide to his left. Slings it. That should have been caught.
Wells flushed in. Down he goes. Brian Schatz, the senior, makes the sack. And now Youngstown backed up all the way to their own seven. We'll have a fourth and a mile coming up.
Rushing three, so you're putting three against five. Schatz with a great swing move, and he didn't have any secondary help. You're trying to double team the guy, and he blows past your first contact so fast, he's able to get back in there and sack Wells. That's a gorgeous play there by, by Schatz.
Boy, and Bo is still yelling at the officials out there.
He's finding anyone with a striped shirt on, and he's just screaming at them.
Something tells me the Missouri Valley may be finding Bo Pelini after this week.
Well, he got one. Like I said, he probably should have had more. But you're right when you said Youngstown's season on the line. You know, the Penguins know they have to win out, and right now they're not winning. They've won most of today, but they're not winning now.
Youngstown, oh, another flag.
There, he finally got another one. That's about to, I'll go back to it's about time. Field judge that time is in front of the bench. Pelini's yelling at him, and he got another one.
I've never seen anything like this in my life.
Nebraska fans have. Instead of the cops escorting the officials out, maybe they should escort him out.
Beth Houle has another Petrosur USA sideline report, Beth.
Exactly what the Youngstown State radio guys told me, that you had to make Youngstown State uncomfortable on the sideline if you were going to beat them. They start to implode. You can see it coming from the man in charge right now as they start to unravel. They start to unfold. They back themselves up here inside their own five-yard line and are really starting to pack it in here.
I mean, he's John again with the field judge. The field judge isn't there, you know, because he wants to listen to it. He's there because that's the position he needs to play or to cover on the field.
Now, two unsportsmanlike penalties. Does he get ejected after that?
Tell you what, I'd throw another one off. There he goes again. Youngstown used his last timeout, I think. No, they haven't used the timeout. I was still trying to figure out what to do.
Fourth and 36. This is a wild scene here in the fourth quarter. My goodness.
Now the offensive coordinator is yelling at the field judge. I know Youngstown has a reputation as being a tough guy town, but there's some verbal abuse happening down there in this fourth quarter.
Bison again will only rush three and drop eight in coverage. They got two guys back way at the 40-yard line.
That's where Youngstown has to be for the first down.
Wells is going to step up. Runs into his own blocker, and then he's just going to throw it up. Batted away. A flag comes in. Oh, wow.
Pass interference.
6 seconds left, and Youngstown State not dead yet. That will move the ball to about the 20.
Pass interference on fourth down. Oh, man. These last few minutes have been crazy.
And again, that only moves the ball into the 20-yard line, so that's certainly not a spot foul.
But right now, Youngstown is in the position of having a puncher's chance, you know what I mean? And now that chance is back there again. To the 19 is where they'll spot it.
6 seconds left. So this should be the final play of the game.
Five Bison players, midfield and beyond.
Wells flushed, got away. Here comes a rush, and Wells is just going to chuck it downfield. And it is intercepted or picked off. Either way, the football game is over, and North Dakota State
comes from 14 down to win it in the final minute. 27-24 your final to move to 8-2.
And I'm just watching where Pliny is, and he's getting a few last verbal jabs into the white hat. Now he's going to go find Coach Kleiman, but his first reaction wasn't to congratulate Kleiman. It was to yell again at the white hat.
And they embrace. And Youngstown State falls to 5-5, and likely their playoff hopes have been dashed.
And the Bison now, with this hard-fought win, have set themselves up for what they really need, and that's a position to get maybe a first-round bye. We'll find out what happens, of course, with Missouri State coming next week. But this is the win the Bison needed. It wasn't easy, but they got it.
Also saw King Frazier embrace with his former teammate over at Nebraska, Avery Moss, and North Dakota State victorious Chris Kleiman with Beth Houle.
All right, Coach, 27-24, you earned every point on that scoreboard. How'd you guys get the job done today?
Because our guys won't quit, and that's Bison pride right there. We were down 21-10, didn't look good, and our guys always believe. They always think they have an opportunity to win. We've got unbelievable kids that have great resilience, and I couldn't be prouder and happier for those guys.
You're heading into senior week now. How special has this group been to you? Just looking forward.
Well, they have me where I'm at right now. If I don't have those guys, I'm probably not the head football coach, so I'm really blessed to be a part of those guys.
Well, congratulations on another win, Coach. We'll see you back in Fargo. All right, guys.
Thanks so much, Beth. Wow, what a scene here in Youngstown. 27-24, your final. We'll be back. We're out of breath, but we'll still be back. 27-24, your final on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. 27-24, your final from the Ice Castle in Youngstown, Ohio. Brian, Sean, Lee Timmerman, and Beth Houle with you. And boy, LT, this had the makings of quite the finish here in the Missouri Valley today.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if any of the other top teams made it out of this. We know the Bison certainly did because you got to watch it.
Here's your stats report brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers.
Believe it or not, the Bison ended up with more total yards, 360 to Youngstown's 349, and that was a stat the Bison were behind for most of the game. Rushing yardage for NDSU, 184 to Youngstown's 225, but then through the air, Stick ended up with 176 yards passing.
And NDSU was able to take the time of possession battle back because of the fourth quarter, where Youngstown State went 3-and-out 3 straight times, and NDSU wins it, is victorious today. As we take a look at our American Family Insurance Chris Heise agency hit of the game, and here it is, MJ Stumpf laying a lick on Itavius Harvin.
Yeah, Stumpf ends up, that was early in the contest, puts a really nice stick on him. Anytime you get both feet in the air and the back on the ground and you're the guy doing the tackling, yeah, you're going to get a couple of high fives and some helmet slaps for that one. Nice hit from MJ Stumpf. He does it again.
American Family Insurance hit of the game. We'll close things down when we come back and have your NoDak Mutual Insurance Player of the Game. Stay with us. Back to close things out from here at Stambaugh Stadium in Youngstown, Ohio. North Dakota State 27-24 victors today over the host Penguins. And our NoDak Mutual Insurance Player of the Game is none other than Bruce Anderson, the true freshman from Florida.
Well, it's special teams is where he got this. I mean, he rushed, he had one big run, but he set the Bison up a number of times with really nice returns on the kicking game. Here comes Anderson again, picking up a couple of big blocks, but we're seeing the reason why he does not have a red shirt on this year. Playing as a true freshman, this is the long run down the sideline that almost gets in the end zone, but Anderson showing his big play ability. That's why he is the player of the game.
NoDak Mutual Insurance Player of the Game, Bruce Anderson. LT, parting thoughts. The last 5 minutes of this football game,
nuts.
North Dakota State able to grind it out, get the ball in the end zone, but really the defense, which struggled to stop Youngstown State through three quarters, really came up big in the fourth.
It had 3-3 and outs, is that right, in the fourth quarter, exactly when they needed it. Gave their offense the opportunity to help set up for that long drive. And they also, I like the patience that Coach Kleiman showed in that winning drive. Still had his timeouts. Didn't worry, didn't get in a hurry, ran the ball, did the things he needed to do, and then got the one call, the critical penalty call to get the ball down to the 6 and then get the game-winning touchdown in with just 30-some seconds left.
Well, North Dakota State remains atop of the Missouri Valley Conference standings, and they have a chance for another conference championship, at least a share of it, coming up if they can win next week against Missouri State. The moon is out, the lights are on, but we're out of here. For Brian Sean, Lee Timmerman, Beth Hull, our entire NBC North Dakota sports crew, thank you for joining us for this telecast of Bison football on KBLY and the NBC North Dakota Sports Network. We're proud to bring it to you. We hope you join us again next week. North Dakota State gets it done in the final minute. 27-24 is your final from Youngstown. Have a great Saturday evening, everybody.